NBC Sports and the United States Golf Association proudly present the 122nd United States Women's Amateur Championship with uninterrupted coverage presented by Rolex. It has been a great weather, good mood week here in the Pacific Northwest. Chambers Bay outside Tacoma, Washington. We're set to crown a champion who will take her place alongside the bedrock legends of the game like Alexis Sterling, his contemporary, and Bobby Jones. Babe Zaharie is one of the greatest athletes of all time. Louise Suggs. Joanne Carter won it five times. Julie Inkster, three in a row. On this Sunday, against the gorgeous backdrop of the Puget Sound, it's Monet Chun, 21 years old, trying to become the first Canadian since 1978 to win the U.S. Women's Amateur Big Ten Individual Champion this spring at the University of Michigan. Squaring off against the dynamic 17-year-old sensation from Japan with the game to match the name, Saki Baba, could be the second from Japan to win. 36-hole final, playing for one of the oldest trophies in the game, the 122nd U.S. Women's Amateur Championship. Time now for a look at our marquee match presented by Rolex. Saki Baba, 7 up through the early 18, rolling like that Burlington Northern that rumbles by the 16th hole. Off her 7-6 semifinal win out quickly against Chun. Baba came into the match rested after needing only 12 holes yesterday. She made 7 birdies in the opening 18. Chun had 5 bogeys. Now let's go down to the first tee in the introductions.
Good afternoon. This is the continuation of the 36-hole championship match of the 122nd U.S. Women's Amateur Championship conducted by the United States Golf Association and hosted by Chambers Bay. Please welcome the players. From Canada, Monet Chun. And from Japan, Saki Baba. The referee for the match is Tom Johnson. At the conclusion of the first 18 holes, Saki Baba is 7 up and has the honor. Play away, please.
So Baba's 7 up lead is the largest after 18 holes in the U.S. Women's Amateur Final since, how's this? Ann Quast, now Ann Sander, held a 12 up lead in 1961. Mitch Lerner with Morgan Pressel.
Yeah. She's picking up Rich right where she left off from this morning.
Drive as good as the views. A comeback from 1895 through 2015. Only one all-international final. It's the third now in the last 7 years. Canada and Japan. Let's take a look at the championship recap presented by Rolex and the morning session. Saki Baba, here she is at the fourth, already with a 2-up lead.
She really just went tremendous golf this morning. Tough to beat.
So she's 3 up. Now her second at the fifth.
This long par 4 gets a nice bounce off the front left contour of this green.
Just like that, Saki Baba is 4 up. Now third shot. Par 5, 8th. One of 5 par 5s here at Chambers Bay. Par of 73. another superb approach shot, and Baba goes 5-up through 8. Now at 13, another par 5.
And knowing her opponent, Monet Chun, was in trouble on the left side with a difficult angle towards this whole location, plays a really smart shot here. I mean, she really epitomized today. Pedal to the metal. Keep it going.
6-up at that point, now at the 14th.
Her iron play has been nothing short of spectacular. She takes dead aim at almost every flag stick. And has made a fair amount of those putts, like that one right there.
Here we are with an enormous lead, but still 18 holes to play. It's great to be alongside the 2005 U.S. Women's Amateur Champion, also a major champion, Morgan Pressel. All right, I'm going to throw the name Laird Sheppard out there. Who is Laird Sheppard? Laird Sheppard at the amateur, the British amateur a year ago at Nairn in Scotland, was 7 down through 18 holes, and he beat Monty Scousel on the 38th hole. It can be done. However weak of a case there is, make it for us for a potential comebacks. What needs to happen? You once did it from 6 down in an amateur match.
What it's going to do is it's going to take nearly flawless golf from Monet. She didn't play poorly this morning. She gave away a few holes, made 3 bogeys on par fives, kind of really gifts. Wrapped them in nice little gift boxes and handed a few holes this morning to Saki. She cannot do that this afternoon, and she needs to make some more putts. I think otherwise she played all right. She just really didn't get anything going in, was a little bit tentative with her putting, and I think she's going to need some help from Saki because we have not seen her make really any mistakes, and she doesn't seem to be bothered by the pressure of a championship Sunday, and she just looks really calm and collected out on this golf course.
All right, Dusty Burkowski knows the amateur collegiate game better than anybody in the world. Jay Cockrell won the U.S. Women's Amateur back-to-back in 86 and 87. Jim Gallagher Jr., 5-time winner on the PGA Tour, great at match play, played the Ryder Cup, once beat Seve. Julia Johnson was a first-team All-America, helping to lead Ole Miss to the NCAA team title in 2021. Catherine Belanger is along from the USGA for any rules situations that may crop up. And let's go down to Julia with Monet Chun.
Going with a 5-wood here, 223 to this hole today. 180 to the front, and I got kick left, I think.
I think that's gonna funnel all the way down, almost down to the 18th fairway. This was a hole she really didn't play well in the first time around. It was actually way right on her second, so I'm not surprised to see her miss this a little bit left, but she's gonna have a tremendously difficult third upcoming.
One of the great things about amateur golf, Kay, is that the galleries can walk in right behind the players.
Yeah, it's really a cozy atmosphere. Baba with this 189 to the hole, 146 to the front. They move this par 5 tees up to make it reachable.
And that's what she has been doing, not even all day, but all week. Just putting it in the right spot that should come to rest right there. But I guess you never know around Chambers Bay. Oh my gosh. That's a really wet area right there too. That's gonna be tricky too. Very unlucky there.
All right, now with a message from the USGA, here's Mike Wan.
We're the USGA. We're over 100 years old. And while I'm guessing you know our initials, USGA, you probably don't know what we do every day.
All right, I'm a 23.7, so it looks like everyone's going to be giving me some strokes today.
Yep, that's us. By delivering core programs like the USGA Course Rating, GIN App, World Handicap System, we unify players from all backgrounds, ages, genders, and skill levels to come together and enjoy this game. What other sport provides a level playing field to anyone, anywhere, anytime? While this is the kind of stage that most of us are used to playing on, we all dream of playing on golf's grandest stages. You probably know us for the US Open or the US Women's Open or for our amateur championships. But what you may not know is we conduct 15 national championships every year to showcase the greatest players in the world. And now with the US Adaptive Open, we've added players with disabilities as well. Yeah, you bet. We govern the game too, together with the RNA, so that no matter where you play the game, anywhere in the world, we all play by one common set of rules. Every year, we invest tens of millions of dollars to advance this great game into the future through Grow the Game initiatives, turf research to reduce water and nutrient demands, and agronomy experts for our courses. So just keep playing. We'll keep unifying, showcasing, governing, and advancing to make sure golf continues to thrive in the next 100 years.
And the USGA is having an outstanding year. Saki Baba 7-up, largest winning margins. Go back to 1961. We mentioned Ann Sander. She won the AM 3 times and, by the way, was from the state of Washington, school teacher in Seattle, and a terrific player. And in the last 60 years, how's this? The two most dominant wins by our team members, Morgan Pressel and Kay Cockrell. And you won your match 9-8, and Kay won 9-7. So you know what it's like to be running out front. All right, Julia.
She had just 43 yards to this hole, 5 paces to work with, and it's a pretty good shot from down there. It was a really tight lie.
She had to make sure she got something up there on the green. I mean, she was right almost nearly on the green for a while, both players, and now, I mean, 43-yard shot back into this hole, it's just so severe left of that first green, Kay.
It is, and you could be tempted to be frustrated if you're Saki Baba with the release out and now facing this really tough little shot, but you know, she did what she wanted to do, hit a good drive, hit a solid second shot, just a little bit of bad luck that it released all the way through.
We haven't really seen any frustration from her all week, Kay.
No. No, really good play right there. Had to ensure she hit it firmly enough. The last thing you want to do is have it come up short and come back towards you.
Saki Baba trying to become the second from Japan to win the U.S. Women's Amateur. The first, 1985, just before Kay won her 2 straight. Michiko Hattori had a good career at the University of Texas as well. Japan of late, land of the rising stars, that's for sure. Tsubasa Kajitani won the Augusta National Women's Amateur last year. And don't forget Keita Nakajima, number one ranked male amateur in the world, won the Asia Pacific Amateur last October.
Rich, I actually talked to Michiko Hattori last night and early this morning via some text messages, and she was just a fabulous person and golfer. I played a lot against her in college. We never played head-to-head in match play. But
come
she said that
please.
Japan,
come
she and Japan
me,
are just so
my shot
excited
when I
for
the
Saki
TV.
Baba. And
all
so
all,
she's
I don't
just
matter.
Become this big no, junior star that. Now. She's this had a huge lady. Breakout summer.
That's what it is. You can tell.
She made the cut at the U.S. Women's Open, finished tied for 49th, one of 4 amateurs to have made the cut. She's co-medalist, U.S. Girls Junior.
This putt will be on the speedy side, and everything slopes right to left. And just like a
I'm interested to see if we'd see any nerves from her coming out to start this second round today, and we've seen no sign of that so far.
What's the challenge when you have a big lead and then you have 2.5 hours of sort of a cool down?
I think you just gotta try and get the job done as fast as possible. I mean, for Saki, she doesn't want to let Monet really think that she has a chance. She needs to keep playing the way that she's been. And yeah, there was a break, get some lunch, maybe rest a little bit, but she was out on the range. We saw her well over an hour before the second tee time.
Let's see if Chun can sort of light the flame of hope right here. Begin to cut into that massive deficit.
Good effort. Just outside that circle of friendship, isn't it?
Baba remains
think
seven
Chambers
up.
Bay, you think 2015 Jordan Spieth capturing that U.S. Open right here, but it wasn't the Texans' first visit to the course along the Puget Sound. Let's take a look at iconic venues presented by Rolex.
After playing in the U.S. Amateur there, I knew that that golf course could show some massive teeth whenever it wanted to, and it wouldn't take much. Because I remember those practice rounds before that USAM thinking, this is a really cool, fun golf course. You can feed it into some hole locations. And then I shot 80-something in that second round thinking, I don't know how I'm supposed to hold a green. So I think my expectation level on how much respect I had to give that golf course may have been an advantage over some of the guys in the field for sure. The way the 72 holes came up, you know, my name was at the top on conquering that golf course, playing it under par, and beating the best in the world on golf's toughest test. Surreal to win the US Open. I just thought that would be maybe the hardest major for me to win. I just thought the way my game is and the way US Opens are set up and the fact that I just don't normally play a lot of patient golf and a pretty aggressive player, I hadn't really envisioned myself holding this trophy as a US Open champion.
Made everything back then when he was 21. Forever 2015 season, doubled 17, but then made the huge birdie at 18. Johnson infamously three putting from just above the hole. That was a thriller. And now it's second Saki Baba.
Going with the 3-wood. .254 down to the bunker where it cuts into the fairway.
First big mistakes we've seen from Saki. It looked like it settled down in some pretty thick rough.
Monet going with driver here. She doesn't hit it as long as some of the other players, but she has a lot of accuracy.
Swing.
You can see the golf course is a lot greener than it was in 2015. They've had a wet spring here. Also, since the issues that plagued that 2015 U.S. Open, the greens have been resurfaced with Poa. For the most part, they've been pretty good this week.
I think the golf course has been set up very well this week, Rich. I think it's showcased well, especially in match play. There's a lot of different ways. The fairways are very generous, but there's gigantic greens with lots of different options and some pretty large slopes where you can use them at times to your advantage, and you can get caught on the wrong side of the slopes as well. So I think that's why it's been such a fun match play course. Greens have been pretty tricky to read.
With that, time to check out our course insights brought to you by American Express. Let's bring in Jim Gallagher Jr.
Thanks, Rich. She's missed one of the few shots she's missed, and she's hit it over in the left rough. But it's a little bit of a kind of a knuckle kind of lie. With this green that moves so much from right to left, I would think it would be at least to the right edge of the green. Let it feed back left. Anything that gets left and long really feeds off to the back left.
Yeah, what about distance does she need to carry this, Jim, in order to use that slope on the right?
I'm going to say it's about 150, but that's a guess. I didn't really get the number, but I'm going to guess that. But with Monet in great shape, great angle coming in there, big advantage for her.
What does she need to worry about other than other than just missing it a little bit left, what's the biggest concern? How it comes out of the lie?
Exactly, because there's about 30 yards short from the carry over to the bunker to release forward, but nothing left is where she wants it. There is enough room on the bank on the right. It will feed left.
I would think that her height and this little bit of steepness in her golf swing should also help her get down on this golf ball.
Let's bring in Kay. Kay, what's impressed you as you've watched Saki this week?
Well, her ball striking has been exquisite. This morning she only missed one fairway, one green. This is just the second fairway she's missed today. And her, kind of the serenity with which she plays and the joy. She actually talked about enjoying playing over here in the United States, that she felt like the tournaments were set up a little more casually in terms of everyone being friendly. I think in Japan, everything tends to be a little more tight and business-like. So she feels like she can be more free and open, which I think has parlayed into the way she's played.
And Kay, she's had a great caddy on the back.
Yeah, he's been a huge asset. Bo Brusher, local caddy. He's caddied in a couple of the USGA championships that have been held here. 118 to the front. I think if she can land this 120, 25 and allow for a release.
She's set up with a pretty open stance here. Doesn't look like she's aiming too far right. We know she likes to take that aim.
Well, it's been a while since she's hit out of the ball, so it could be a little...
It's like a video game. It just doesn't miss the target. Knows exactly where it's going.
And that's so disheartening, Julia, for Monet to watch that. She thinks that she might have an opening. Finally hits a shot offline and yet recovers beautifully.
Yeah, there's just not really been a chance for Monet to cut into this lead at all. She's in a beautiful position fairway though. 135 to this hole, just 106 to the front. It's gonna hit something about 128. Using that right slope to feed it in towards this hole. This is a really good shot up the right side of the green.
Excellent. Look, maybe you just don't focus on the green seven down. Go try to play a great round, shoot five under. Which she's capable of doing. You never know what might happen. The 122nd U.S. Women's Amateur Championship is brought to you by American Express. Don't live life without it. And by the all-new Lexus LX600. Experience amazing at your Lexus dealer. Saki Baba. 34 seed coming in. The seeding hasn't seemed to matter a whole lot in this championship, that's for sure. Chun was 53. Saki Baba's road to this championship match, 73-74. It is par of 73 here, and they're playing it at about 6,500 yards. Close in that opening round match, then she beat the co-medalist Alice Zhao, just 13 years old. Sayamana Tapa from Ohio State, 3-1, relatively easily over Lauren Lehigh, and then Bailey Shoemaker, who had been playing so well. Shoemaker was one of the stars of this championship up until getting boat raced yesterday, 7-6. Shoemaker beat her future teammate at USC, Amari Avery. Shoemaker will be a high school senior. And she is already committed to USC. In terms of seeding, the last five champions, Schubert was a 43 seed, Gilman 24, Gabriella Ruffles a 6 seed, Rose Zhang 16, and then last year Jensen Castle won as a 63 seed at Westchester. Bringing Kay once again. Just a gorgeous day, isn't it, Kay? I know you you've loved walking the fairways and the high dunes, all of it this week.
I do. I have to admit that I love just about any golf course that's right next to a body of water, particularly the ocean. And this is, it's stunning out here. And this is a day that is absolutely perfect. Just a wisp of wind, a little cool breeze. It's gorgeous. This putt is a 20 footer that will move just a little bit left to right. And Monet will pay attention. Yeah, as her putt is very similar.
Pretty quickly across the hole there at the very end. Ran out of just a fraction of pace, but if Monet was paying attention, like you said, Kay, she'll know exactly what this does. She's from a slightly different angle though, Julia.
Yeah, I think she has a little bit of a straighter putt. This will move left to right the whole way, but coming back up that hill a little bit, she has less of a slope to contend with. This will be a big putt just to instill some confidence in herself and her stroke. She's been putting the ball so well all week. To get this one to go in would be a real big confidence booster.
Yeah, she just didn't make anything this morning, Julia. Didn't see anything go in. Definitely could use this one right here.
Yeah!
Woo! That's a start.
Yeah,
right
girl!
There.
Let's go!
One, three, Baba, four. Baba is now six up.
That we've seen today.
Monet had a look on the first hole, capitalizes there on the second. Been a great week here at Chambers, a great year for the USGA. Let's look ahead to 2023 USGA Championships, some notable venues. U.S. Open L.A. Country Club, the Women's Open at Pebble Beach, Women's Am at Bel Air. I think we'd be running a few miles from the East Coast, heading out to California on multiple occasions for USGA Championships, and weekly ticket packages are on sale for next year's U.S. Women's Open, presented by ProMedica at Pebble Beach. Visit uswomensopen.com/tickets today. The champion earns a spot next year at Pebble, so too does the runner-up. Assuming she remains amateur, I have a good sense both of those young ladies will be looking forward to that experience at Pebble Beach in 2023. Making their way over to the par 3rd. This was a hole this morning that Saki Baba won with a par, but coming off that win, a birdie, something to build on. Monet Chun will have the tee, Julia.
Yeah, I always loved being able to hit first on these par 3s and put a little bit of pressure in against your competitor. If she hits a good shot in here, Saki knows she has to respond. This is a really great par 3, though. 138, tucked in that back left corner. There's a big slope in the middle of this green, kind of near that back bunker that these players can use to feed the ball down there. Just looking to hit something. 133, 134, short of the hole. Let it use that slope towards the pin, the hole location today.
It's almost a bit of a Rodin-esque green here as everything funnels to the back left. If you miss the green well to the right, it could potentially pick up enough pace to get all the way to the flag, but the camera tower, left side of our camera up there, is a good target. Greens are firming up a little bit, Steve.
Yeah, you can hear the little thump when that short iron landed. Now Baba.
Yeah, I think she's looking to hit just about the same shot. Not very used to hitting second, certainly off the tees, as she has controlled the match the first 18, hit the honor most of the time. She hits a higher ball going more directly at the flag.
Right as you said, Morgan, you could see it, you could hear it, that big first bounce.
Yeah, and it hers all because she took more direct aim, but almost landed a little bit on that downslope.
So they make their way to the green, and we caught up with Monet Chun yesterday, and she explained to us how she navigated some turbulent times with her golf game.
There's definitely some parts where I did want to step back, and I think definitely taking a couple breaks in between, letting myself rest and think things over again was definitely the big thing for me. There were little periods of time where I could see like improvement through what I was working on. So if I was practicing putting, then my putting would get a little bit better. If I was practicing chipping, my chipping would get a little bit better. So just being able to see that, I think, got me through that last couple of years. And now I feel like my game is at a good spot, so I'm pretty happy about it.
You go back 3 or 4 years ago, Monet Chun struggled to break 80 or 85 after being one of the top-ranked juniors in North America. She worked hard, made the necessary changes, went through a lot of bad golf to come through on the other side. And as Jan Dowling, the head coach at Michigan, told me, no one would have blamed her if she quit and walked away, but that she's one of the most patient, smart, enduring optimists she has ever met. Remarkable perspective because of her maturity and what she has experienced. Morgan, the story of Monet Chun, one of great perseverance.
It's really tremendous. I mean, to think of what she's been through, I think also maybe doesn't make today seem so insurmountable. You know, she's been kind of a coming from being one of the top juniors in the world to barely being able to break 85, and that's so tough. Her coach, Matt Wilson, texted me, talked to him a little bit during the break, and he said, you know, it's just so gratifying to see her compete on this stage given where she's been. And he flew in early this morning from New Jersey to watch. He's just so proud of her. And no matter what happens today, it's pretty special for the two of them to have this day here as well.
And it's not been just this week for Monet Chun. She won the Big Ten Conference Championship this past spring. She won the Canadian Women's Amateur just a couple of weeks ago. So considering where she was 3 or 4 years ago, to get to this championship match, hard not to root for the young lady from Canada. Baba away.
Caddy pointing at a spot about a foot and a half left of the flagstick. From her perspective, it's gently back uphill the entire way. Always interesting to see how a player manages the first couple of longer putts. The first hole, her speed was excellent, lagging it up to tap in.
Bit of a bobble there coming out of the fringe. I think took a decent amount of pace off that putt.
So Monet Chun, Julia, an opportunity for another birdie and another win.
Yeah, good luck here, about 30 feet. She got to see a little bit of what Saki's putt did at the end. It should tail a little to her right. Pretty flat, not a very quick putt. She can give this one a run.
I gotta point out, if you move your ball mark over, you better move it back, otherwise it's loss of hole, because that happened to me at Positampa in 1986.
We don't remember things very long as golfers, do we?
We remember our mistakes pretty clearly.
You never made that mistake again?
Never.
Chun now for 2 in a row.
Yeah, just never got it out far enough to the left. Not sure if that was a push. Couldn't quite tell from that camera angle. Earlier today, she was coming out of her putts a little bit, standing up pretty quickly. It looked like she's staying down nicely through this one.
So par conceded to Monet. Baba, short one to tie the hole.
And these are the ones you practice relentlessly, because knowing that you can make your three footers just frees yourself up on the longer putts and lets your opponent know that you have your nerves in control and that you're not going to give up anything easily.
Wow.
Here's a gift.
That's
John
3. Very
Baba generous
four.
Gift.
Chun is now 5-0.
And that's what Kay talked about. You know, we'll see here a little, there is a sign of nerves. You might see it right there. And Monet even looks surprised and walking away from this hole.
But she'll take it. Two straight wins for Monet Chun. Started the afternoon 7 down to Saki Baba, now 5 down. You got to win 2 in a row to win 3, Morgan.
Got to keep it going. That's given Monet a little bit of hope here. And it'll be interesting to see how Saki responds to this. We've seen her make 2 mistakes so far today. One, that drive left on 2, and then, of course, missing that short putt right there. The only couple of mistakes we've seen all day, at least, I should say.
Yes, quick moment to let you know that we want to see the game prosper in the future, and that means getting more kids into the game today. Time now for a message from the USGA.
If golf is going to be successful for the next 30, 50, or 100 years, then we have to make the game more accessible and welcoming to the next generation. The USGA is committed to junior golf programs, including drive, chip, and putt, the first tee, and LPGA USGA Girls Golf.
Programs like LPGA USGA Girls Golf are important to bringing young girls into the game because we specialize in creating girl-friendly environments to keep girls engaged and eventually become lifelong golfers.
The first tee here creates the framework for a child to be successful through these lessons that we're teaching.
Sparking a lifelong passion for the game starts at the junior level. So if we want a more diverse future for golf that's welcoming and accessible to everyone, it's important to lay that foundation.
As they make their way over to 4, we talk about growing the game. We've seen a lot of kids, young boys and girls out here all week. One of the great parts about these championships, Morgan, that there are no ropes. You can get right up there on the tee box, around the greens, and let these youngsters see what they possibly can do in the future. All right, they're heading to this par 5 fourth hole. Good one, Morgan.
Yeah, called Hazard's Ascent, straight up the hill, this par 4. Ideally want to keep it up the left. It does lengthen the hole a little bit, but it gives you a much better angle into this green. Fairways here are so wide, and there you see it's almost a split fairway. There's a lower half to the right and a higher half to the left. But here, the hole location all the way on the very back right today, which is why coming in from the left side gives you a much better angle. There's a little bit of a slope that you can use on the left to get it close to the hole.
So now it's beginning to get interesting. You think maybe I'll stick with this and a chance we'll see an all-time comeback.
She
likes it.
Yeah, just up the left side, ideal.
It's going to give her a better angle, not going to play quite as much uphill, which I think is important for her slightly flatter ball flight, definitely compared to Saki, to get it close to this hole, okay?
You know, hopefully Saki Baba has had some really good positive self-talk in the last couple of holes, saying, you know what, it's a long day, it's a lot of holes, of course my opponent's going to win a couple of times and just brush it off. Don't let it shake your core.
It's interesting because she does not have very much match play experience. So she's, one, never had a massive lead, and also hasn't really had too often where she's lost a few holes and gotten tight. So all in all, she's relatively inexperienced in this format.
Time now for a look at our marquee match presented by Rolex. And in fact, Morgan, Saki Baba has now lost the last 2 holes. She only lost 1 in the previous 23.
It's just, I mean, she's played such beautiful golf. She's got a wonderful golf swing, very repeatable. We really haven't seen any weaknesses in her game. We've seen her chip in, we've seen her make putts, we've seen her iron play just right at the flagstick all week.
Let's go down to Jim.
Thank you, Rich. Both players have hit the left side of the fairway. Now it's decision time. Do you go for it? Do you lay it up? Monet's ball is, I'm going to say it's about 220 to the front, but it's going to play uphill 10, 12, 15 yards. So if she wants to maybe get to that front left, pretty good idea because this whole location is back in the right corner, as y'all talked about. And we'll step up here probably another 15 yards, probably 205 yards to the front for Baba. I think she can really go at it. Even if she hit it in the front right bunker and got it far enough up in the bunker, it wouldn't be a bad play.
Yeah, I think the more left with today's hole location you can be, the better there, Jim. There is that slope to the long left. What about do they have to carry on that bunker that juts out in the fairway?
That doesn't look like that's the problem. It's probably about 150, 60 yards. The problem is if you go through the fairway, then you get it too far left if you go too far left. I think if you go at the corner of the bunker, if you're going to lay it up on that angle, that's the place to hit it. That's the spot they got to look at.
Yeah, I think what we saw from Monet earlier, she had three bogeys on par fives. She needs to really dial it in here. This is a moment in the match where momentum is starting to shift in her favor, and she needs to take advantage of this hole and at least put some pressure on Saki.
And something to consider, just finding out, we'll monitor throughout the course of this afternoon, but during that lunch break, Saki Baba was getting her back massaged, was icing it. Her coach asked for a heating pad too. Just going with the facts and see if in a long week that could be an issue.
It's interesting, Steve, because I was wondering if she walked off after hitting the tee shot here. She had her left hand kind of on her lower left back.
Hey, it's been a long week. We saw Catherine Rao earlier this week. You know, the back can tighten up, but just something to monitor over the course of the next couple of hours.
All right, Julia.
Just going with a hybrid here. She walked up and pulled this club very quickly. I think she knew what she was going to do.
That'll be just fine there, as Jim said. Didn't get it so far that it's in the rough. Should be able to put some spin and control that.
To the fans that decided to walk all the way up to this fourth green where they could just have stayed down at the fifth green and waited for play to turn around and come to them. It's a hearty bunch out here.
Right until they get to the seventh. This is a grueling walk here. 200 feet of elevation change from the highest point at 9T all the way down to 17 green.
Saki staying aggressive, which has been her mantra all week. 195 to the front, which plays 210 to the front, trying to get it maybe on that left front.
So her feet are aimed a little bit left of the front of the green. Playing a little bit of a fade.
Actually, pretty straight shot, and that was really well played. That was well thought out, exactly where she wanted to go.
Sure if this is going to come back off this false front. But still, really, that was a good, solid golf swing.
Trust you're enjoying this uninterrupted coverage of the 122nd United States Women's Amateur Championship is presented by Rolex. A lot at stake. Your name etched alongside the foundational greats of the game. We mentioned Alexis Sterling, Louise Suggs, Babe Zaharias. The list keeps going. Joanne Carner, the gold medal. You would know, you've had your hands around the most beautiful trophy in golf, the Robert Cox Trophy. And then all the exemptions. We talked about Pebble Beach and then the other majors.
Yeah, and I think that if you think about the history of the game, and as you mentioned, all the names on there, it's probably something that these players maybe don't realize right now. They don't realize how special that is, but they will as time goes on. And I would say I was the same. You're out there to win a championship. You're not so much thinking about the history and what it all means, but it's such an honor. And I know Kay feels the same way, to have our names on that trophy along with the greatest players in the sport.
I think over the time period that you have it and you can look at the trophy and really soak it in and look all those names, it really resonates.
Patty Berg won it. Carol Semple Thompson. Beth Daniel twice. Danielle Kang back to back. Lydia Ko.
And Julie Inkster still to this day says the three in a row that she won are it's her crowning achievement.
Canadians, Kathy Sturk, 1978. Like Monet Chun, that year also won the Canadian Women's Amateur. The first Canadian to have won it was the great Marlene Stewart Street, who is a member of the World Golf Hall of Fame. That was 1956. She beat Joanne Carner, who then went on to win five beginning the following year. All right, Julia.
Yeah, just 104 to his hole today. Has to still worry a little bit about this bunker in front of the green. Needs to carry about 99 yards. There's a small ridge on the left side that she can use.
They can go to the left.
Really good shots here. Okay. Yeah, that's second 18. That is outstanding.
This is what she needed to do, Rich. She needed to come out and see some good golf.
Just go play a great round, right? We saw some low scores in the medal play portion, right? There was an 8. There was a minus 6. I mean, it's out there.
And her coach, Jan Dowling, talked about how much patience she has, how she's one of the most patient players that she's ever seen, something that she wishes all of her student athletes could embody, the patience that Monet has. And maybe that's just going to be enough to help her today.
You wonder about comebacks any part of weeks ago at the junior AM. Win Yi Ding, who ultimately won, was 8 up with 8 to go against Caleb Surratt. Surratt won 5 straight holes to extend that match to 16. So sometimes you get a gift, sometimes you make a putt, next thing you know, that snowball effect happens.
You want to get your opponent thinking, uh-oh, I can't blow a 7-up lead.
Rich, that leads me to talk about the first year I won. I was 6 up after the first 18, and at lunch break, it was at Paso Tiempo, we all went up to the Marion Hollins house to have lunch, and people were congratulating me, saying, you got it in the bag. We walked in, I sat down for a few seconds and said to my caddy, Dan Rosenberg, let's go, I can't listen to this, I have to stay fully focused. We grabbed a sandwich at the snack shack and sat on a bench in the parking lot and just kept the momentum and kept it easy, because no lead is big enough.
Morgan, how'd you handle your big lead when you won?
I remember sitting in the corner of the clubhouse with my grandparents, with my caddy, with a couple friends who'd flown in for the day, and the same, just trying to not listen to the chatter around. I remember my team saying, it's not over, keep the pedal down, keep being aggressive and attacking, and that's not what's happened so far.
Okay, how about this play here?
I would expect Monet Chun to use this, employ this, but I understand it because she has to negotiate a hump, and she almost would have to put it up into the fringe. And so she envisioned what she wanted to do, landed it on the more flat area, and that was gorgeous.
And that is the shades of Gary Woodland at, we mentioned, Pebble Beach when Woodland won the U.S. Open in 2019.
I think Kay made a good point there. No lead is big enough, and it's tough to close out matches. It really is. It's tough to close out tournaments with a big lead. It's tough to close out matches in a match play format.
Especially, Morgan, when everything about match play is so much more emotional and so much momentum about momentum, and momentum switches. You talked about it even within one hole, how it can switch back and forth. You cannot let your opponent start feeling and creating her own momentum, which Monet has just started to do.
I saw Monet walking up to this green with a little bit more of a pep in her step.
This is a big spot right here, Kay, because Saki has a chance to reclaim some mo, put some heat on Monet Chun here by making this putt and then sort of regain her footing.
Everything came so easy for Saki Baba on the first 18. Like I said, hit almost every fairway, missed just one fairway, just one green, put it beautifully. and Monet was a little off her game. So there's the difference. There's the advantage. Now Monet is kind of a different golfer.
Back on Monet Chun.
And I talked to her swing coach, Matt Wilson, a little bit a while ago before they teed off, and he said that Monet is just going to come out here and play as free as she can. He said she feels like she's playing with house money. And that's all she's played so far. She just looks really loose and a lot freer than she did this morning.
Look, Steve touched on it. Given where she was not that long ago, struggling to break 80. It's a gorgeous day. She's in the final. She already got a ticket to Pebble Beach next year. Go have some fun. Try to do something special.
This will move right to left on her, just 4.5 feet.
That hurts.
She can't afford to do that after winning the last two holes. That was an opportunity there to keep the momentum in her favor.
For a moment there, given the degree of difficulty, the up and down for Baba, it looked like it could go to four. But instead, there's match play. It's right back to six.
Momentum on each shot there on that fourth hole. Saki having, 8 feet, making it. That makes Monet's putt a good bit longer. Didn't look like a bad stroke.
Still, you have three par fives ahead. If it gets to the 18th, that's a par five. A chance to make some things happen. You have a short four at the 12th and some par threes. And now to the fifth.
Good par four, Morgan.
Yeah, beautiful hole, as Kay mentioned earlier, right back down towards the water. Generous fairway, as most of them are out here. Pinches in right at about 250, 260 off the tee, but still plenty of space out there. What you really want to avoid is this lion's mouth bunker that stares everybody in the face right in front of the green, and today right in front of the hole location.
Baba's
good ball.
Tee shot on the way.
Another beautiful drive. She hits such a lovely, high, long, straight drive.
Okay, she's pretty tall already and apparently is still growing. And her role model is Nelly Korda. So they both have kind of similar long arcs. Obviously, both very tall.
All right, Monet Chun.
She's very accurate off the tee, and she'll need an accurate one here. Headed up the left side of the fairway, should catch a piece.
It does. Looking to get your child started in golf? Remember that the USGA is a co-founder of Drive, Chip and Putt, a free program focused on fun and the free fundamental skills in golf. Register today and find a qualifying site close to you at drivechipandputt.com. The USGA, the good folks at Augusta National, have really made that commitment to grow the game. It started in 2014, in less than a decade removed. We're seeing players at the girls' junior, the junior AM, a few here this week as well, as we send it down to Jim Gallagher.
Thanks, Berko. If we take a look here, both players are very similar spot. The sprinkler right there is 153, the hole location. So Baba's going to have about 155. This is about 160. This hole's cut just over that bunker. And from Monet's ball, probably want to keep it just left of the flag, maybe let it feed in there. That's probably the safer shot. But we've seen Baba many times go at these hole locations. If she does do that, she's got to be precise with this yardage coming here. Probably play uphill, maybe a half a club.
And who do you think has the advantage here from and with regards to height that they hit it into this green with the hole location only about, what, 6-7 paces over that bunker?
Great question. I think Baba obviously has, with the way she's hit it, the height that she hits it, she has the advantage coming in here. I feel a little bit of wind. I don't think it's enough to affect the play or the shots, but I mean, if I'm Baba, I go right at it the way she's playing.
Actually, earlier today, she used that front left slope to get it close to this hole location. It's one of the few times we've seen her play away from the flagstick. I don't know if that was on purpose, to be fair. Might have been a bit of a pull, but it worked out in her favor. Earlier today, she went on to make about a 10-footer for birdie.
Yeah, Baba won 4 of the first 5 holes in the morning session. Uninterrupted coverage of the USGA Championships is presented by Rolex. Chambers Bay has been a wonderful host for their 4th USGA Championship, open in June of 2007, just 15 years old. Think about your Uline winning here as the top-ranked amateur in the world in 2010. Jordan Spieth at US Open in his great run in 2015. Maybe this is the hello world moment for Saki Baba, saying, watch out for me moving forward. Making their way down the fairway here at the 5th. Both players in the fairway, and Monet Chun along with her mom on the bag. Started caddying in the round of 16. We touched on it earlier. Big Ten individual champ in the spring, also leading the Wolverines to their first ever conference title. And then just a few weeks ago, with the Canadian Women's Amateur Championship. So Monet Chun certainly has been trending in the right direction. And when you take everything that she has been through, sort of under a microscope, hard not to tip your cap to this young lady and say, way to go. We all know at any level of this game, Morgan, the valleys make you want to go the other way.
This game is really hard, and we very often on television see those that are winning and those that are in contention, but we don't see those that are really struggling and what they go through, and it can be enough to make people give up.
First to go.
She has 154 to this hole location. She does come in with a lower ball flight, like y'all were talking about earlier, so I think it's advantageous for her to use that slope on the left side. She tries to carry this all the way to the hole. Might go a little long.
I think ideally with her ball flight, needs to use that front left slope to get it close to the hole.
Once it's headed at the left.
Might be too far left. Oh, and she hits off the down slope. The shot, the little bit of a pull draw, that's her miss. Her coach Matt told me that's kind of the shot that she fights a little bit, and that did not end up in a good spot.
And then you think about what just happened on the prior green, perhaps a carryover, thinking I might win 3 in a row, and you get one back. Now Baba's turn.
Yes, as Jim talked about, it's just a little bit of a deceiving hole. You cannot see the green. That bunker obstructs the flat part of the green, but she trying to take it up that left side a little bit, and we're seeing the firmness of these greens now, aren't we? Took a huge bounce.
When play began on Monday, there were 9 USGA champions in the field, all of whom have their names etched in history. Time now for a message from the USGA.
The Hall of Champions is really an amazing place, and one of the greatest parts of my job is when we have a champion who walks into that room for the first time.
Oh my God.
When they walk in, it quickly dawns on them what the Hall of Champions is all about, and when they find their own name, there's usually a very quiet moment that follows, as it hits them in a very deep and fulfilling way.
It's amazing, and all the history here, and like you see these names, all the legends that got their names here, so it's pretty cool.
These walls hold the names of every single USGA champion. You can stand in the middle of this room and understand the history of the game in the United States.
Hip, hip.
Expect anything different?
They are champions forever, and that's what this hall represents.
I'm really looking forward to next week in Oberko. You'll be there. You're going back to your home state of New Jersey for the U.S. Men's Amateur. That's at Ridgewood. first time Ridgewood will have hosted the AM since 1974. A guy by the name of Dave Repetto, sort of the club historian there, and the membership, they've reached out to a lot of the competitors from 74, and I'll share some of the names. They went on to superstardom, and they're going to bring them back for a special dinner midweek in Paramus, New Jersey. How about this? Jerry Pate won. He was a senior at Alabama at the time. 2 years later, he hit the five iron in Atlanta, win the U.S. Open. But in that field at the 74 Men's Am, Curtis Strange, who was at Wake Forest, Peter Jacobs, and John Cook, who will be in the booth with us next week. Cookie won the AM 4 years later. Craig Stadler, Jay Haas, Gary Cope, Stu Francis, who's now part of the executive committee at the USGA, Fred Ridley, chairperson of Augusta National, and short game guru Dave Peltz, all played in that 74 AM, and quite a few will be coming back next week. It'll be really special.
Great week in New Jersey. Stu Francis going to help me with the trophy ceremony in a couple of hours. And Julia, I'm thinking, where were you in 1974 as you get ready to watch Monet?
My mom wasn't even born yet, so.
Take that, Burko. Old man.
Yeah. That was great, Julia. Well done.
That's a really difficult shot. The grass was going into her ball. Really hard to judge how it would come out of that line. She did a great job.
That was pretty phenomenal right there. I mean, you have no control out of a lie like that. And we've said all week that her hands are pretty special and her short game around the green is top notch. Showed it right there.
I thought Julia's shot at Burko was almost as good.
Yep, zinger of the week. She got me at Marion, gets me at Chambers Bay again. It's all right, Julia. I'll remember that one.
It's all with love, Burko.
That's all that matters. Great shot there by Monet Chun. Now Baba, next to go.
Again, I'm going with a sand wedge versus a putter. Just practicing a little even-tempoed motion. Just going to try to clip this. Little left to right break initially, then it should straighten out. Looks like pretty good speed.
Come on.
Remarkable watching this 17-year-old here at Chambers Bay.
Yeah, just golf clap for that shot right there. That was, we saw her chip in on 7 a couple of days ago.
Hold out at 12 a couple of days ago. The few times she has been out of position, the recoveries are first class.
Burko, that gave me chills.
Just enough.
She was 6, and then she just won this hole.
To your point, Steve, nothing really seems to have flustered her whatsoever. A poor shot, a poor bounce, none of it has fazed her, and she's just continued to take dead aim and swing away.
Was in the quarters. Let's talk about the chip in.
And the lines around these greens are not that easy to chip with a lofted wedge like that. They're very tight. And that was a quick chip down the hill. We've talked about potentially taking putter at times, but Saki's shown beautiful touch, especially the last couple of holes.
A little surprised she's going to try right here. Not really needing it on the short hole, but she is aggressive by nature and she's staying true to that.
It'll be interesting to see as her game progresses and she gets a little bit older, if she learns when to use the aggressive nature. Certainly this golf course is relatively forgiving off the tee, but it'll be fun to see her game progress over the years.
Swing.
Oh. Well, if your daughter is aged 6 to 17 and interested in golf, enroll her in LPGA USGA Girls Golf, a program that the USGA has supported for more than 25 years. Help empower and energize girls in golf by visiting girlsgolf.org today. It's the fastest growing segment in the sport. Young girls. Jimmy, your girl dad have been for a long time. The whole family plays the game. I know how much you love it.
I do. My son Thomas and I lived in a sorority house, as we always tease, because we had all those daughters. But it's great when your kids are out there playing. I get more of a kick of watching them play, as I know a lot of these parents do, getting out here to watch these great players. But they both got it in the fairway. A little different angles coming in here. From right here, it's a perfect angle. Right about 110 coming in. They've got to carry it about, this ball right here, about 103 yards to carry it up there. And that's Monet's ball. So gets it up that upper slope. There is a little bit of a backstop. I think it's a very accessible hole. We'll head over here to the left side where Baba's tee shot is. A little different angle. Not that it's that difficult, but something to take a look at. Coming in here, the bunker could come into play. She'll have to carry that bunker. And the grass is just a little bit, maybe a little bit lighter, not as thick and not as green as over there.
Well, the one thing that both players have to be careful of here, Jimmy, is not to go long.
Yes.
It's exceptionally quick from above the hole.
And even from this left side, you could kind of feed it from left to right and feed it back into the hole. That may be a play as well.
Now, you know you're a gamer when you got your name on the back of your yardage book there. As Jimmy's got his Gallagher Jr. we saw peeking out of his back pocket.
I just reiterate, Jimmy had a great match play moment at the Ryder Cup in the 90s. He beat the toughest match play competitor Europe's ever produced. Seve Ballesteros. Saki Baba.
Rich, it changed so quickly in 30 minutes. Monet Chun wins two in a row. Great chance to pick up three straight. And just like that, Saki Baba gets both of them back.
Morgan, you know you played a lot of Solheim Cups and you won this championship. Match play can turn on a dime.
It can, and you, as long as you have holes left to play, you really can never give up. And I have not seen certainly any give up in Monet out there, but the opposite for Saki. She saw that she lost a couple of holes and decided, you know what, I got to get right back in this thing and get back to my big lead and continue to put pressure on Monet. Like I said, she just has seemed so unflappable today. What does Monet need to do here, Julia?
Yeah, she just has 101 here, about seven paces beyond that front ridge to this shelf in the middle of the green. Her swing coach calls her the honey badger, says she has a lot of fight in her. We're going to need to see it right here in the next few holes.
Tough one.
The flag stick is a little towards the back of center on this long, slender green that, rather than actual tiers, has long transitional slopes. And I think where Monet Chun left it, that's going to be a pretty fast putt. Ideally, I'd like to keep it just left of the flag and a little underneath.
You'd have to think Saki's caddy Kay would know that.
Yeah, I've been a caddy here for 13 years and caddying in a couple of USGA championships. He knows this course like the back of his hand.
Just diving in all day, all week.
You can't hide the flag stick from Saki Baba. Uninterrupted coverage of the 122nd United States Women's Amateur Championship is presented by Rolex. Been quite a display by the 17-year-old sensation from Japan, Saki Baba. Monet Chun's had a wonderful week, but she's in against a buzzsaw right now, trying to fight back. Canada against Japan. of all the great Japanese women, to Chako Higuchi, Ayako Okamoto, Ai Miyazato, Hanako Shibuno more recently, Masahata Oka, and maybe the next great female Japanese player in Saki Baba.
I think we have a real superstar on our hands here, Rich.
And you don't throw them out, the kudos out lightly.
I just don't see any weaknesses in her game. I don't see any holes. I mean, maybe because we haven't seen her in a bunker. I don't know what her bunker play is like, but that's pretty much about it.
You're going to put this on the channel?
Morgan, I saw her in one bunker. I think it was quarterfinals on the 17th when she hit the sprinkler head and it went over the green. I don't think we showed the shot, but it was a remarkable over-the-green bunker shot, so she does have some game in the sand.
Yeah, she did. That was an unlucky shot that she didn't get flustered by, that she recovered from beautifully and ended up winning the hole.
Monet Chun. We mentioned Marlene Stewart's free, Kathy Spur. We're talking about amateur golf in Canada. You have to mention the great Gary Cowan. He won the U.S. amateur twice in 1966. He beat Dean Beeman at Marion, and again in 1971. Legend.
I want to talk about the mound.
In Canada.
She's stepping off. She's taking a second look at this part right here. Very fast, moving right to left the whole way. It's really easy to get these putts going low initially. It's important to keep it high and give it a chance to go in. Only 12 feet, but a difficult putt for Betty.
It's just so tough. That's such a fast putt from up there, and it's easy to be tentative. In this situation, I really can't afford to be tentative.
Jim talked about his house of young girls growing up through the years. Saki has three sisters. And it was funny the other day, I said to her dad, I said, "Hey, that's why you're so laid back and so nice. You got a house full of girls." And he goes, "No, that's why I'm poor." So that was pretty funny.
It's a great line, Kay. Jim can probably relate. The no holes. There's no holes in her game that we have seen. Her mental game, her physical game, every little aspect of her play so far this week has been just tremendous.
This morning, Morgan, she won three in a row at 3, 4, and 5, two in a row at 7 and 8, again at 13 and a 14. And then after losing two straight, she wins three in a row for the second time in the first 24 holes of this championship match. You run out of superlatives when talking about this 17-year-old. Take a look at the individual amateur championships held by the USGA. This one dates back to 1895, right there alongside the US Amateur and Open, the inaugural three for the USGA. But boy, through the decades, so many great ones have popped up. The Junior Am, the Girls Junior in the late 40s, Senior Amateur in 55, the Women's Amateur in 62, the Mid-Ams, and the venues that we have seen in recent years, Morgan. Amazing, as good as any, a bucket list for a lot of these amateurs as the USGA played in their 50th state, the US Senior Women's Amateur, last month in Alaska. How about that?
And the USGA really committed to going to just these venues that we've seen historic championships over the years. And each one of those historic venues being played by these amateur events and even like next year at Pebble Beach, it really elevates those events.
Baba now on the tee at the seventh.
Interesting to see how close to the sand she takes this. Yep. Challenging it right over it. Beautiful drive. She is in some kind of mode right now.
Continues to play well and also throwing the Women's World Amateur Team Championship 10 days from now in Paris. Rose Zhang, Rachel Heck, Rachel Keane representing the ladies for the United States. Now Monet Chun.
She's taking this a little bit further left in the center, but it needs to carry to get over this bunker, and it does.
Down there by Baba. A quick reminder to let you know you can get 12 months of Peacock Premium when you join Golf Pass Plus. Stream live sports events like the FedEx Cup Playoffs, in addition to monthly tee time credits, waive fees, and all the benefits of Golf Pass Plus. Visit golfpass.com to join and claim this limited time offer. And among the many things you can get, elite access to Jim Gallagher up by the green here at 7.
Boy, isn't that special. You got to love that. Both players took it up that right side, which is the aggressive side. They can see this flag stick. They can't see the putting surface. But you've got to get the ball, carry it all the way up here. If you don't, trust me, it's going to roll back about 50 yards. So as they get up here to the green, in 2015 in the U.S. Open, this hole played 210 over par, hardest hole on the golf course. It's been very difficult this week. The hole's cut all the way back on the left, on a little over the little bit of a ridge. As they roll it up here, if they can get it all the way up there, that's going to be just fine. However, if the ball gets a little bit to the right, it'll feed over here to the right. And if you go long, very difficult if you hit it over there long and left. So look how far that ball is going over to the right. So that's just about 15 feet just right of the hole. So they have to be aware of that. Also, as I said, if you go back and left and long, that's going to be a tough chip shot.
We know how difficult this seventh hole has played, not only this week, at the U.S. Open in 2015. It's one of those, Morgan, if you can make a four in stroke play or match play, you're usually ahead of the game.
Yeah, make a par and run, and a lot of it is the severity of the green, the blind second shot, the firmness of the greens as this green is firming up. I think that'll make the back hole location a little bit more accessible, but Monet here made bogey the first time around this morning to the same hole location. They kept the hole locations the same between the morning and the afternoon session today.
And then you throw in the fact it's 72 feet from the tee up to the green. It's just a big, steep climb. You feel it in your quads. You've played now your ninth round of golf this week. And I tell everyone,
I like it.
The U.S. Women's Amateur and Men's USAM are the ultimate endurance test, both mentally and physically.
Kate, what did you find more difficult, the mental side of things or the physical aspect?
Probably the mental, especially on a day like today when you've gone through so much golf, the 2 days of qualifying, winning all those matches, you make it down to the final two, and it's right there for you. And it's so easy to think about holding the trophy, but you have to stay in the present and keep executing shots.
Julia, the same can be said trying to win an NCAA championship as you helped the Ole Miss Rebels in 2021. The amount of golf that is played over 6 or 7 days.
It's really hard to stay in the moment the closer you get to that trophy. You want it so badly, you kind of envision yourself and your team holding it up. And I think Kay's right, the mental aspect of it is so difficult. You have to really stay in the present.
I'm sure the other 154 that started the week would swap out with Baba and Chun right now, no matter how fatigued they are. Baba set to play.
People down here, you know, clap because they like the look of the shot and the line it takes, but you have no idea from the fairway what the result is.
That's going to break a ton right to left off the slope coming off the back of the green.
All right. right, Monet.
140, but it plays about 10 up from this portion of the fairway. Really a good advantage to know where this hole was located earlier in the first round. It's on a good line, just barely left of the hole.
It's going to slope down all the way to the left. It's going to come back, I would imagine. That's going to be a really tricky shot. We've seen her chip well off these tight lies, but that's going to be very quick. Greens are so firm, it's just tough to get it close.
We're starting to see a little fire in the greens at Chambers Bay. 17-year-old Saki Baba, 21-year-old Monet Chun. Their very first U.S. Women's Amateur Championship. In fact, all four of the semifinalists were playing in their first, and six of the eight quarterfinalists. Their debut start in the most prestigious amateur championship in the entire world. We take a look at some past champs since World War II to win it. Their very first go-around. Some pretty good names there. Mayim Zaharias, Evan Daniel, Vicky Goetz, Sylvia Cavallari, the last European to win this championship. Most recently, Gabby Ruffles in 2019, and Sophia Schubert 5 years ago, almost won a major championship in the mix at Evian last month. You touched on it, Morgan, though. I feel like the last 2 days, the firmness, the fire of these greens, maybe not as receptive as we saw maybe 4 or 5 days ago.
Yeah, we saw it earlier in the week, and that's the thing with this championship spread out over so many days. The golf course is bound to change. We had rain the first day that we were here early in the week on Wednesday, then fog on Thursday, so definitely a lot more moisture in the air earlier in the week, but we've had now 4 days, 3 days of absolutely beautiful weather bound to firm up this golf course.
And really, Morgan, just one late afternoon where we had maybe up to 2 clubs wind towards the end of the day. Other than that, there's hardly been any wind. It's been amazing.
The type of day that I'd like to go play golf. This is my kind of weather for golf.
You said that the other day, Rich. Kind of afternoon, you want to sling it over your shoulder and chase it. It can happen out here at Chambers. Who's away? Is it Baba?
I haven't seen the signal, but it looks to me like it is.
It's interesting, Kay. Saki is very, very determined in her personality. She might be young and relatively inexperienced, but she always writes down every little detail about every shot in her notes. How far the ball landed, how far it released. She's very analytical, which is interesting considering her age.
It appears to have a very mature golf IQ, and that's a great idea for people at home to remember, because you can refer back to those numbers. How far did I carry that 7-iron? How far did it release out if you're on another hole trying to decide what club to hit?
This now for birdie.
Breaks that much. That's uphill to start and then downhill at the end. That's a tendency.
See what Chun could do here from left of the green.
She really likes chipping with her 58 degree. She's found a portion of this first cut that's not very thin, so she might be able to put some spin on this ball. This is a very difficult chip off that downslope.
Yeah, that was not her best, considering we know how good her hands are. This, I think it's going to end up stopping on the green, but I think she could have done a little bit better than that. That wasn't exactly what she was looking for.
Uninterrupted coverage of the USGA Championships is presented by Rolex. months ago, Monet Chun started building some momentum, won two straight holes, now in danger of losing four straight to Saki Baba.
And her demeanor has stayed really calm. She and Saki were walking up the last fairway together and smiling and looked like they were laughing together, so I don't think she's very upset, but you know she wants to win a hole or two and maintain some of that pride she has for making it this far.
Yeah, I think that goes back, Julia, to her patience and her perseverance over the years and what she's been through. And I mean, I think we saw that even we had a close-up of her after that chip. She didn't look too mad at herself or down, and we haven't really seen any of that body language today, despite the situation.
Has shared with both you and me that's sort of her demeanor. She does not maybe outwardly show a whole bunch, but whether things are going well or it's a bit of a struggle, that's the MO for Monet Chun. So Baba's going to have a putt here to win four in a row and go nine up in the match.
And the way Baba has played today, she's brought her A++ game, and no one was going to touch her unless they brought equally good a game. I mean, so few mistakes today this afternoon. The three putt at the third hole was her mistake, and then what does she do? She comes back and birdies the next three holes. So never parlayed one mistake really into another. Center shafted putter. I might have to look into getting one of those.
Her reaction after that was funny. She almost didn't think that was going to go in and is just kind of laughing at this point. Like maybe she herself didn't even expect this kind of a match today.
Hard not to be impressed, Morgan, as they head over to eight.
Yeah, this is a long straightaway par five. There's two tiers in this fairway, the high road to the left side, the low road to the right side. Ideally, would love to keep it up the left, but the thickest rough on the course is just left off the fairway on this tee box. Players have a choice to send it all the way down there towards the green up the left, or everything slopes a little bit down to the right side if you are to take it up the right. Again, this hole location, the very back right today, a big slope behind, but we watched Monet Chun use that earlier in the match and it didn't work out well for her. It came spinning back all the way off of that top back shelf. So really have to be dialed in with your yardage control on the third shot.
Just been dominant, except for this hole. This par 5-8. Again, five par fives here at Chambers Bay.
I'm really enjoying watching this swing. It just seems so simple. Inefficient.
It's repeatable.
Mm-hmm. She actually used to hit a little bit of a draw, but her coach suggested that she start to learn to hit a little bit of a fade to improve her score. So this year she switched to hitting a touch of a fade, and it's not that easy to do.
Just doesn't miss the middle of the club face all that often. So she's nine down with 11 holes to play. Celebrate this great USGA championship and inspire your game. Check out all the official championship merchandise right now by going to usgashop.com. Saki Baba has made what? 10 birdies in 25 holes. 10 and 25.
I mean, I wouldn't say that Monet has played poorly. She's had a few mistakes, certainly on the par fives in the morning round where she's given away a few holes. But for the most part, it has been the Saki show, and she has just put on a performance for the ages.
It's been a clinic. There's something artful about the way she plays. It's a wonderful, soft set of hands.
You think that's my brand? You take that spot.
Yeah. It's a proud day for Japan. And they've had so many good moments in the last couple of years. We've detailed some of them. Tsubasa Kajitani won the Augusta National Women's Amateur. And then 5-6 days later, Hideki won the Masters. And then we mentioned Keita Nakajima. Later in 2021, won the Asia Pacific Amateur Championship. He's the number one ranked leader in the world. And now here we are, Saki Baba strolling to the U.S. Women's Amateur title and doing it in resounding fashion.
Japan has put out a tremendous list of young ladies as well. I mean, you think Nasa Hataoka has been really a superstar on the LPGA Tour for the last handful of years. And I go back to thinking about what the Olympics has done for golf, and specifically Japanese golf. Being in Tokyo last year, all of these global golf organizations investing in their youth, and these countries from around the world, specifically Japan, are starting to see the benefits of all that effort that they've put into growing the game in their countries.
They've improved their coaching. In Japan, they've gone to a more holistic approach. They're preparing their athletes for the international stage.
Needs a fortunate kick out of the rough here. Is she gonna get it? Similar place to where she was in the morning session.
Nice shot.
I need to stop here.
Wander down the road. We suspect she will turn professional. When she does, if she'll hire Bo Brushard as her caddy. So we're going to watch this one with the Tracer technology, and it's brought to you by Lexus, the official vehicle of the USGA.
Yeah, taking this down the left side. Morgan, you made a good point about maybe hiring Bo at Pebble.
Hey, caddied for what, about 5 years at Pebble Beach? Mm-hmm.
And you know, a couple people out here told me that every champion who has won here has had a local caddy on the bag.
It shows how much inside knowledge and how much there is to learn about this golf course. And just I think any time you can have a local. When I even went for an advanced look at championship golf courses, I would usually take a local with me and my own caddy so that we could really learn the ins and outs from somebody who's been around the property a million times.
And you think about the history of this part of the country. In 2010 at the U.S. Amateur, Justin Thomas had a youngster, if you will, called Michael Greller on the bag, middle school teacher not far from here. A year later in 2011, Greller was on the bag for Jordan Spieth as he won his second junior amateur championship. Look what they have done in the past decade since. So maybe something in the Pacific Northwest could translate to a nice relationship moving forward.
Yeah, Griller and Spieth had quite a moment right here in 2015 at Chambers Bay. Baba is on her way to her first USGA championship. All time, most USGA titles won, no surprise. Jones and Tiger Woods argue who the greatest amateur of all time was. Would likely be Jones simply because of the professional tournaments that he won additionally. Carter won five U.S. Women's Ams between 57 and 68, and then went deep into the professional ranks. Jack, we know about. Ellen Port at 60 will next month try to win a fifth U.S. Women's Mid-Amateur title. And she was in the field this week. A couple of 60-year-olds in the field, and then we had a couple of 13-year-olds only in golf. We talked about Ann Sander from the state of Washington, three U.S. Women's Amateurs, and then the Hall of Fame great Carol Simple Thompson. Chun first play.
She has 81 to this hole location, located 45 paces on, very back portion of this green. Just looking to hit something, the number. She can use that slope behind the hole, but it might spin it back a little too much.
Play. She learned from her mistake this morning, throwing it way too far up on that backstop and spinning back. Good play.
I suppose Michael Greller graduated beyond the status of local caddy here in 15, but he certainly was a caddy who was local. This tandem has worked really nicely together. 66 paces to the hole. Taking it all the way back there, ensuring she got it to the tier, the back tier.
Get it in that slot every single time. The 122nd U.S. Women's Amateur Championship is brought to you by the all-new Lexus LX600. Experience amazing at your Lexus dealer. And by American Express. Don't live life without it. We did record some golf earlier today at a bare minimum. It's just nice to sit back and enjoy the views of some of the holes on the back nine, which we did capture earlier today. So a remarkable story how Chambers Bay came to fruition. It was an old sand and gravel mine last used in 2003. Former county executive by the name of John Ladenburg came up with the idea of building a course here after having watched the O2 US Open at Bethpage Black, which is owned by New York State. This is owned by Pierce County. The county bought the 950-acre site back in 1992. It's a recreational area with parks and walking trails. And this golf course moved a lot of earth to make it happen. Robert Trent Jones, Jr. And we tip our caps to Jay Blasey K. He was kind enough. He was on the design team, kind enough to walk us around here earlier in the week.
Yeah, he described a lot of the process of creating this golf course, and he lent his notes to quite a few players through the years to help them understand how to play this course, and which I have to tell you that walking these fairways with the locals, a lot of locals here very proud of this golf course. They want to know, what do you think of Chambers Bay? What do you think of the course? And it's hard not to say anything but positives about this place. Yeah. This putt is downhill. And we have some pull to the left.
Mm-hmm.
voice.
Virtuoso performance.
It's very special. And it is history making. And I mean, like you said, her hello world moment.
At a certain point, it's not so much about the score. It's about the beauty of what you're watching.
Baba 4, Baba is now 10 up with 10 to play.
Go to the ninth hole now and bring in Jim Gallagher.
Thank you, Rich. There's so many beautiful holes, but this is one of the coolest holes on the golf course. We look at the ninth. It's 174 yards, but it's playing 23 yards down. Player's got to carry the actual number about 161. And there's a lot to this hole. There's the hole locations over on that right side, and that's the cool part, is you can kind of use the slopes to kind of feed it back in there. But the big thing is there's a little bit of wind here from coming maybe to the player's left. They got to be able to factor that in with the 23 yards down. This is a big shot. I think anything just left of the hole, feedback down, will be key.
Here's a great look at some of the elevation changes here at Chambers Bay. Nearly 200 feet at certain positions on this golf course. And Rich, you talked about it. 1.5 million cubic yards of sand moved around this property.
And Berko, there was good sand in the areas of the pit, and a lot of the grading for the golf course was done to harvest and mine that sand, and they used it to cap the whole site.
Yeah, in fact, in the 1990s, there was more sand and gravel coming out of this mine than any other mine in the United States. Saki Baba's on a bit of a tear now, has won 5 consecutive holes.
I have to say I'm a fan, and I was a fan before today. I just love her name. I think she's got the greatest name in golf right now. It's fun to say Saki Baba, and I think she's gonna generate a lot of fans throughout the world.
Especially because she's got the game to match.
Mm-hmm.
Tracer technology brought to you by Lexus, the official vehicle of the USGA.
This looks like an excellent line.
This little just simple fade that she plays with her irons, is she is so precise. It's made us all up here a little speechless. You know, what do you say? It's so good.
Great shot. Another good one. Now Monet Chun.
This is headed out to the left, towards those people on the left side. Might grab that slope and come all the way down.
She might get away with this one.
Chambers Bay in a nutshell. Almost ends up in the same spot as Saki Baba. So we'll have a couple of birdie putts here at the ninth. Take a look at the overall seed of the eventual champion of this U.S. Women's Amateur since 2017. Sophia Schubert, 43rd. Kristen Gilman, 24th. Gabby Ruffles was a 16. Rose Zhang, 16. And then a year ago, Jensen Castle had her survive a 12-for-2 playoff just to make match play. Saki Baba, a 34th seed on the cusp of becoming a national champion.
Man, you know, it's interesting. She qualified for the Women's Open earlier this year at Pine Needles. And going into that event, she really swung 100% at everything. We've seen her take pretty good swings at her drivers. But after playing in the Open, Open alongside of the professional, she realized that most of the top players are controlling their turn and are not hitting shots, very rarely hitting shots 100%. She's been working really hard to incorporate those thoughts more into her game. And I think that's what we're seeing. We're seeing these tremendously controlled iron shots on nearly every hole. Certainly a lot of confidence taking dead aim almost everywhere, but she is executing to perfection.
I don't know if she's going to let us have her by herself first, or if they're going to want to take
and
her down.
And I think, Kay, you were front and center to the show last week at Muirfield at the AIG Women's Open, where there were four Japanese players in the top 15. And we're going to go back to talk about the tremendous play from young Japanese players that we've seen the last handful of years.
Yeah, I think all these federations across the globe, in particular Japan, has always had a great tradition of golf, but they're really upping their game. And I think Steve alluded to something really important, trying to maybe change the coaching and the atmosphere. They've always been so intense and put so much pressure on their golfers. Maybe try to loosen it up and be one more lighter.
Second biggest golf market in the world, behind only the United States. Well over 1,000 golf courses. History in golf in Japan stretches back to the early 1900s. Tokyo Golf Club, that was the first club established by and for the Japanese. That was in 1913. It was a really big moment in the 50s. It was a huge boost. Torikichi Nakamura and Koichi Ono won the 1957 World Cup. That was at, you mentioned the Olympics, Morgan, Kasumigaseki in Japan. That's where they had the Olympic Games. They beat the legendary duo of Sam Snead and Jimmy Demerit by 9 shots, and Nakamura won the individual title by 7 over Gary Player, and that really jump-started the game in Japan. And then, you know, Chako Higuchi, she was the first Asian-born player to win a major. We mentioned Matsuyama, but it was Higuchi on the women's side in the late 70s. She was the first. Now, Monet Chun.
Downhill, very quick, moving left to right the whole way. And that was a good stroke.
If you think about women's golf in Japan, they're truly superstars, like Hollywood actors here in the United States. And I remember being in the Osaka airport and seeing a 20-foot tall picture of Ai Miyazato walking to security. And that is the stardom that these players, even the women coming out of Japan, are revered in their country. It's fun to see them embrace the women's game.
All right, Kay. This is it.
This is it. And this one, the cap off to just an amazing performance. Just cozy this down here. It's been some kind of special moment this week to watch this young woman.
Close match, but in lieu of that, you love to watch greatness, and that's what we saw. We've
seen a rip from Saki, and you kind of felt like that was going to go in, that last putt, just to put a cap on the tremendous tremendous performance that she's put together, especially today, nearly flawless. She's so much fun to watch.
Now, how about this? She played 106 holes in all in this championship. That's the same number you played. Second fewest number of holes needed by a champion at the U.S. Women's Amateur. How about that? 106. Goes back to 1970, second fewest. You did it in 05. And while we have a moment, let's go down to Kay Cockrell.
I'm alongside Beau Brushert, who has been a caddy here for over 13 years. And there were a lot of local caddies that were used for the week of the U.S. Women's Amateur. It was sort of a random assignment that you guys got paired together. What has this week been like for you, and what did you observe throughout the week in her that sort of made it appear that she is extra special?
Well, the week was amazing, first of all. Second of all, I knew right away just her poise, her composure was amazing. I learned her game a little bit in the first two practice rounds last weekend and just noticed she was an amazing putter. Her pace all week has been phenomenal. I don't think she had but maybe one three putt all week, and that's what won it for her. She's amazing. You know, if she makes one mistake or gets down on one hole, she bounces right back, just like you saw in number three today on the second 18, but she's amazing. Yes. At those flags.
Well, talk about her maturity level. Just 17 years old, just the third USGA event she's played here, her first U.S. Women's Amateur Championship, and she goes on to win. How did that happen?
That's a good question. She's just a great player. Like I said, her poise, her composure, you know, she fires at the flagstick. She has no fear at all, and she played phenomenal all week. And I think, like I told you earlier today, like Thursday kicked in and there was a trust factor between both of us that just kind of really came about. And on Thursday morning, she started making some putts and getting some confidence. And you know, her putting obviously is what won it for this week. So it was a lot of fun to watch.
Well, you guys made a great team. You were a lot of fun to watch. And I know this is going to be one of your all-time great golf memories. Congratulations. Let's go over to Julia Johnson.
Monet, I know this isn't how you wanted the week to end, but 156 girls started, and you're one of two still standing. So how proud of you are you to get to this moment?
No, I'm pretty excited to be here just to represent Canada and Michigan especially. I'm just excited to be here right now.
At what point in the match could you kind of see it turning, and could you see Yaki kind of gaining some momentum?
Yeah, I think it was at some point in the first round she made a birdie putt and I missed mine, and I think that was kind of the turning point. And there was definitely some other parts out there where she made a couple more putts, so yeah, just through the whole match, I think.
You've earned a spot next year at the U.S. Open at Pebble Beach. How excited are you for that, and looking forward? You have such a great career ahead of you. So how excited are you of that?
No, I'm pretty excited. I haven't played a professional event yet, and I'm going to tee it up next week at CP. So after that, I think I'm going to gain some momentum for next year.
Awesome. Back to you, Rich.
Thank you, Julia, and congrats to Monet Chun. She had a great week.
She really did, and everything that she has been through and persevered, it's wonderful to see her game trending in such a positive direction.
And so it is the third largest winning margin. Ann Sander, 14 and 13 in 1961. The great Glenna Collette Vare, 1928. But this matches the Babe. And anytime you're in the same sentence as Babes and Harrys, you've done something special. For the ceremony, let's go down to Steve Burkowski.
Rich, thanks so much. What a day, what a week here at Chambers Bay as I turn it over to USGA President Stu Francis.
Thank you very much. We really have had a special week here at Chambers Bay. The weather, the competitors, the site, it's just been spectacular. I'd like to start out and first thank Chambers Bay Golf Club. We've now conducted four USGA National Championships here in the past 12 years, and you've been gracious hosts every time. In particular, we'd like to thank both the staff and the volunteers of Chambers Bay for such a first-class presentation of the golf course and the championship conditions that we had. We had a great match today. Monet and Saki, congratulations on how well you played. And at this point, we would like to present both the Robert Cox Memorial Trophy for the U.S. Women's Amateur Champion and the gold medal to Saki Baba.
Saki, congratulations as I bring you in here alongside Teresa Kimura, who helped with the conversation. You've had a wonderful stretch of golf, especially in the United States. How were you able to be so dominant in this championship match today?
My caddy san to ma iroiro hanashiatte iroiro na nanteiu no kana. まあ、キャディーさんとの意見も合ってたり、まあ、やっぱり自分のパターとかもよく書いてくれたのですごい嬉しいです。
I think it's probably been my caddy, Bo, who really helped me with this.、the way we were reading everything was good, so that's what brought, plus、my putting was pretty good, so I think that's brought the win.
Everything was pretty good. On the outside, you looked very calm. What were your emotions and nerves like on the inside on this championship day?
I just kept on thinking of just winning, just winning, just winning, and just do my usual golf. And just the whole time I was thinking, I'm going to win, I'm going to win.
Well, you did win, and you now become the second player from Japan to win this U.S. Women's Amateur Championship. What does it mean to you and all the folks back home in Japan?
What do you think?
37年ぶりっていうのを聞いていて、でやっぱりその服部道子さんの次に名前を残すことができたのは本当に嬉しいです。
Hearing that it's 37 years since she won, being able to put my name next to her is really, really, surprising and very happy.
Well, it was very well deserved. It was an absolute pleasure to watch you, Saki Baba. Congratulations on a great week.
ありがとうございます。Thank you.
Rich.
So many admirable qualities in Saki Baba: humility, grace, touch, and determination.
We saw all of that front and center this week. Just an absolutely dominant performance from Saki. It never looked flustered. Like I said earlier, she has no holes in her game. And I think it's great that she gave her caddy such love there in that interview, because having him on the bag, I think, really helped keep her in the moment and help her play this golf course.
Take you all the way back to the opening 18 this morning, and Chun had difficulties right there at that par 5 first. She made bogey, and she's one down.
She made a few mistakes, especially early in this morning's match, that took a 4 down deficit maybe to about 7, but
she made 5 bogeys in the first 18, and Baba made 7 birdies, one coming right here. That's a recipe for a gigantic margin. So now the second at 5.
Just her iron play this week. I know that her caddy in that interview mentioned her putting, but I think a lot of it was due to her tremendous iron play.
Bo Brushard also said she fires right at those flags, no fear at all. Chun, this par to tie the hole. Let's see, so she's 4 down very quickly. It doesn't get a whole lot better. Third at the 8th for Saki Baba.
Monet knew coming into this day that she was going to have a tough match. She was going to need to bring her very best, and Saki certainly did.
Another birdie right there. So Saki Baba is 5 up through 9. Now on another par 5, the 13th.
Her opponent in trouble with a difficult third upcoming. Smart play here off the slope. She ended up winning that hole.
6 up through 13, and pouring it on now at the 14th.
This is a moment where Monet felt like she hit a good shot in here on the 14th and maybe could start to claw her way back in. And then Saki goes ahead and does that, Rich.
Yet another birdie for Saki Baba. 7 up after the first 18. Early in the second wave.
Yeah!
Monet Chun's making a little move here. Got interesting for about 15 minutes. Baba had this to tie the hole, and you thought, okay, she's now only 5 up. Maybe she's start to think a little bit, feel the heat.
Gun free.
That absolutely was not the case for birdie here.
That was a really solid putt after the short miss on the previous hole, and that's where we realized that door was closed on hope for Monet.
That was the par 5 fourth hole right there. And this.
Saki.
Let's go 8 up. Saki Baba. Out of the 25th hole.
Tremendous touch and feel, but this was not one of her best and would lead to another loss of hole.
Now it's just a matter of time. Saki Baba was merciless, relentless. Amazing putter, her pace phenomenal. That from her caddy, Bo Brusher. And this was it. Needed only 2, but give one big championship. Saki Baba, 11-9 over Monet Chun. Now the second from Japan to have won the U.S. Women's Amateur, all the way back to 1985, and Chico Hattori was the first. Both players earned the exemption to the 2023 U.S. Women's Open at Pebble Beach. And there she is with the oldest trophy in the USGA's collection. It's the Robert Cox Trophy. I think it's maybe the most beautiful in the game.
Like this area gets up late summer. Where even in
what a week. And I mean, every now and then, you and I have been, you've been playing it for a pretty long time. I've been watching this game for a long time. You come across a player that stops you in your tracks. And we don't know. It's risky to start trying to project teenage golfers. We've learned our lesson. But you can't help but think the sky's the limit. And if not, this was just an historic performance.
Her performance this entire week, and especially today, was just beautiful to watch. And it was fun to just kind of sit back in this chair and watch it unfold. She was unflappable, even when she made a couple of mistakes early in on the second 18 today. Just nothing fazed her. I mean, we talk about no holes in her game. She's got the long game, the short game, the putting, clearly. But she's got the mental game, too. She's got the mental toughness, and we saw that all week, and especially today.
Kay, how about your thoughts?
Well, first of all, I said it before, I love her name, Saki Baba, and when I heard about her at the U.S. Women's Open, I just thought, who is this young woman from Japan? And then she was one of four amateurs to make the cut, and it was very obvious that she had game, and I'm just amazed that someone from another country who's just playing here for the third time, playing her very first U.S. Women's Amateur, goes on to win it. She showed so much poise, and she did it the old-fashioned way, hitting a ton of fairways and greens, and then her putting capabilities were just something to drool over. And when she went out there, her caddy Bo said to me after the break, and she had the three-putt on the third hole, he said, I think that woke her up and just got her re-engaged back into the fact that she had to keep fighting for that win. No lead is enough of a lead. So I love the way she immediately bounced back and didn't let that affect her confidence at all. And she's a bright star. I really look forward to seeing what she can do next. And like you said, Rich, if she doesn't do anything ever again, this is going to be a historical week and something for us all to cherish and say we were there and we saw it.
And I think we're going to see a lot of her in the near future with this win. Certainly gets into Pebble Beach, but often the amateur champion invited to the AIG Women's Open, invited to the Evian Championship. So I think we'll see a lot more of Saki in the future. What do you think, Kay, is next for Saki regarding her home country of Japan and dealing with the media coming out of Japan?
It's going to be, I think, a big shock to her when she goes home and sees all the celebrations, and I'm sure she's going to have countless requests for interviews, and I hope she just takes some time to really relish what she's done and enjoy the attention, but not let it get to her head, which I don't think it will. And she may have a little bit of a letdown after this, which is very natural. It's happened to all of us, but a lot of bright things for her coming up in the future because of this win. And there's one thing for sure, she's going to be a U.S. Women's Amateur champion forever.
And Kay, you said it earlier, it's one of the best names in golf, and I would say, you know, as announcers, we love good names. One of the better names in sports, along with, I'll throw Peekaboo Street out there, Mia Hamm. You can't go wrong with Tiger Woods, right?
No.
Coco Crisp. Yeah, I think we've all come to know very quickly, in about 5-6 days in the world of golf, that young lady right there, Saki Baba. And then there's Monet Chun. Steve did a wonderful job detailing her story, persevering through a terrible slump. Julia Johnson had a chance to follow today and all week. And Julia, what struck you most?
Yeah, I think Monet is just such a gracious player. She's walked around Chambers Bay with such poise and kindness. She never lets herself get too far up or too far down. And I think she has a really long career ahead of her. It obviously wasn't the day she wanted today. She didn't get to make as many putts as she wished she would have. And those three bogeys on the morning match just kind of really put her in a rut she couldn't grab herself out of. But she's a really great player, has a ton of accuracy off the tee. And I think she has a long career ahead of her.
I think she showed a lot of poise, and it was fun to watch Monet kind of break out for her. After winning the Big Ten Championships just a couple of months ago, the Canadian Amateur 2 weeks ago, and now in 2 weeks heading to the CP Women's Open in Canada. What do you think, Julia, is next for Monet Chun?
Yeah, I think she's going to do really well in this next year. I mean, this gives her so much confidence, and it's such great experience to know you made it to the finals in a tournament like this. She's beat some amazing players, and she played really great golf all week. So I think she can take this and learn from it and move forward, and she'll play some really, really good golf coming up, I believe.
And a good lesson, I think, for not just young golfers, but really for anyone. Given that she struggled to break 80 not that long ago, the old adage that successful people see adversity not as a stumbling block, but a stepping stone to greatness. She's dealt with adversity really beautifully. Let's bring in Jim Gallagher Jr. Jim, we enjoyed all your shot and golf course setups all week long. Just curious, Chambers Bay was under a little bit of a cloud of controversy in the 2015 U.S. Open, won by Jordan Spieth, because of the greens, a confluence of events, the weather at that time. I know how
proud they are out here of this golf course and how much they want future championships. What's your assessment after this U.S. Women's Amateur?
Well, when you walk on this property, the views are breathtaking, and the walks are breathtaking as well, trust me. But I think just the support they had, the hard work they put into it, Chambers Bay showcased itself. It was wonderful. It was perfect for this championship. We saw some great golf. Tender Par was medalist. We look at that. We've seen some of the best players in the women's game, but that's a youth game. And you're seeing so many of these young players come out here and really handle the pressure. But the golf course held up. It was fun to watch. The weather was fabulous. I think that they've learned a lot from 2015. They improved a lot. And I think we're going to see some more championships here. It's perfect for match play. It was so much fun to watch.
And you mentioned the age, Jim, as well as the level of play. I mean, the average age for this championship was in the teens,
yep,
under 20. And what did you see out there on the ground with the level of play this week?
I saw a lot of personalities. I saw some fantastic play. I think we're seeing players. We also see it in the college game where we see them in front of cameras. We've seen players this week that have never really been in front of cameras. They've been interviewed by us, and they handled themselves really, I don't know at that age I could have done it. So I think it was fantastic the way they held up, just all the stuff off the golf course. The golf course, they had that handled. But just the way they handled the pressure, it was really amazing to watch. Yeah, they hit some poor shots, but they always kept fighting, and I think that's one of the things we take from this. They were able to showcase their skills. Chambers Bay showcased itself as well.
Jimmy, you did a great job this week. We loved everything that you brought to the telecast. So here it is. Just one more note on this golf course and the value of it for future championships. It's a municipal golf course, which we like. West Coast, that gives you a primetime showcase back east, and the views are, as you can see, absolutely breathtaking. Time now for the Rules of Golf, presented by Rolex.
All right, Catherine, you won that hole, and I've been struggling with my putting all day. I'm actually going to stay behind and practice my putts a little bit. We've got no one behind us and a little bit of weight on the tee.
Bailey's allowed to practice putt on the putting green of the hole just completed, and many golfers don't know that this rule is actually the same in match play and stroke play.
We're playing match play today, but you mean to tell me if we were playing stroke play, I could also practice after I finish the hole?
Yeah, in match play and stroke play, you can practice putting or chipping on or near the putting green of the hole just completed.
Putting is one thing, but I heard you say chipping. I flubbed a chip earlier that I would have loved to redo, so I could take my wedge, my ball, right here, right now, and I can drop that and just practice chipping.
Yep, as long as you're on or near the putting green of the hole just completed, not in a bunker, that practice chipping is allowed.
That is great news. My short game definitely needs the work, but to emphasize, so long as we're not holding up play behind us.
Right. The other thing is you'll want to check the local rules of the course you're playing, because there is a local rule that prohibits this type of practice, putting and chipping.
All right, I think we're next up on the tee. It's clearing, so one more chip and we're off.
Seven-and-nine victory for that young woman, Saki Baba. Uninterrupted coverage of the 122nd United States Women's Amateur Championship. We've enjoyed that all week long. And we did have some outstanding play from Saki Baba in the morning session. And here now a look at some of what happened.
Moment ago at the ninth, the par three, Saki Baba with the five up lead against Monet Chun, her tee shot.
Shot.
It's gonna get better, isn't it?
This is gonna settle down nicely. Monet is digging a really big hole right here, and Saki is not giving her an inch.
That's, I think, the key point to hit on. Baba has not really opened the door for Chun again, too. This was just a short time ago.
We saw her hit a few holes late in the round yesterday, similar to what we saw there. Tends to be her miss, and that's going to leave an absolutely brutal putt, Steve.
Yeah, it is. We saw a long one at eight that she three-putted. And in some trouble here in the early going, Julia.
Yeah, this will be a very difficult two-putt. She's having to contend with this massive slope on the left side of her ball. She kept it in the front portion of the screen, didn't utilize that slope like Saki did. She's going to have to look about 12 feet outside this hole.
Morgan, we know a lot can change a 36-hole championship match, but when you're on the first nine of a Sunday and you might head to the 10T, five or six down, how do you try to turn it around, figure out maybe a mini goal at the break to feel like you can get back in it?
Well, I think you can't wait till the break at this point. I think you kind of need to start to put the pedal down. We know that with everything that Monet has been through, that she has a tremendous amount of patience, but you gotta, even though it's early, you almost have to start feeling like your back's up against the wall and you gotta make something happen. And Saki's just really not giving her much of an opportunity to get back in this match. That's beautifully done, Julia.
Good effort there by Monet Chun, but Kay, after the great tee shot by Baba, a birdie opportunity to go six up.
Yes, and a really good birdie opportunity at that. This is one of those putts that most golfers love. A little bit downhill, don't have to worry about the ball getting there, and it has a bit of right to left movement. Saki Baba has just come out with full intention of winning this championship. I mean, making three birdies in the first five holes and going up to that quick lead, four up through five holes.
It's kind of what we've seen from her all week, Kay. She just has not made many mistakes. I mean, would she make one mistake yesterday? She's made one mistake so far today on the sixth hole, but...
And when your opponents see that, not so much the stellar play of making birdies, but the fact that no mistakes are being made, you can feel really defeated, and it almost forces you to feel like you have to do something beyond your human capabilities.
Going six up, so an opportunity for Monet Chun to tie this hole. She can roll this one in, Julia.
A nice lie putt to get it to here for par, just 5 feet. Coming back up that hill. Might move a little right to left on her. She saw the end of Saki's ball. Really important to get this one in the hole after the three putt on eight.
Nine holes of this championship match.
Yeah, that from earlier today, and Saki Baba would go on to win it convincingly, 11-9. Time now for Legendary Champions, presented by Rolex.
I think people that necessarily don't watch amateur golf still watch the women's am, the men's am. There are just some events that catches their attention. The US Women's Am was probably the biggest of them all. It was probably one of the championships that I really wanted to win. I think I had some expectations just because no matter what event you play, whether you're a professional or an am, there are some names that are expected to do well, and I think I was one of them. Oh, this game, Marie Green was played a lot of great golf, and she played great golf even to the last moment, so it was a tight battle.
Olivia Coe is the champion.
It might have been the first time I cried from happiness. I remember Minji Lee, who also competed in that championship. She came out and watched me play in the finals, and then I saw her and I hugged her and I cried. It was super memorable, so another thing for the memory.
Well, grown up now and a great one, and now holding that Robert Cox trophy is Saki Baba with her
caddy Bo Brushert, who was so good all week long. Local caddy here at Chambers Bay, also spent some time at Pebble Beach. Figured they'll be together in 2023 at the U.S. Women's Open. And now we'll take you back to some of the golf from earlier today.
We're 9 holes into this 36-hole final match, and it has been all Saki Baba so far. She's 5 up against Monet Chun, 10th tee, and Kay's there.
One of the most beautiful holes on this golf course, named High Dunes. It is going towards the left-hand side. Bunker's cut in on the left, but things are going her way. She skirts it.
Takes a lot of good golf, but sometimes a little bit of luck to get the job done.
Julia Johnson's with Monet Chun.
And she is very consistent with her driver off the tee. She doesn't miss a lot of fairways. She doesn't have a ton of length, but she has a lot of accuracy.
Swing.
She has a tremendously repeatable golf swing. Why she is so consistent.
Poised and polished. To 17.
Yeah, she's been impressive to watch, Rich. I mean, and even between her and her caddy, they don't have a tremendous language barrier. They use a good bit of sign language, but they seem to be getting the job done pretty handily, especially today and yesterday's match as well.
Yeah, veteran caddy here at Chambers Bay has also worked at Pebble Beach. Well, we have a moment down to Jim Gallagher Jr.
Thanks, Rich. Well, Monet's ball's right here in the middle fairway. Perfect angle coming into this whole location. It plays uphill about 6 steps. And the flag's cut all the way back on the back left. There is a slope just short that she could feed it off to. As we see here, Saki Baba got very lucky to not go in that bunker. She's about 10 yards a little bit ahead. Same kind of angle coming in here. So both players in perfect position off the tee. The key shot here is getting the fairway. We've seen players struggle with the uphill. It says 6 yards in your book. Probably play more like a club and a half to get up there.
What do you think is the best way to get it close here, Jim?
I think if they can take it just right of the hole location, maybe use that slope, but hit plenty of club. There is a little bit of a backstop behind it. Key here is trying to figure out how far up this hole this is playing with the uphill.
390-yard, par 4, 10th. First of 3 straight before they get to the par 5, 13th here at Chambers Bay.
Well, whether it's the rules, handicapping, conducting 15 national championships, or bringing new people to the game, the USGA is focused on the good of the game for the next 100 years and beyond. Visit usga.org/about-us to learn more. Just gorgeous here in the Pacific Northwest, powered by the Puget Sound. Let's go back to the golf from earlier today.
Nice little crowd set against the magnificent Puget Sound on a glorious Sunday here in the Pacific Northwest. And Monet Chun first to play at the 10th, 5 down to Saki Baba.
157 to this hole today, trying to use that right slope that Jim said. This is on a good line, just a little left of the hole.
To stay up there, that could have easily funneled off the edge of that bunker. But again, just a little bit of a tug.
All right, Kay, how about this second shot for Saki Baba?
The ball is sitting on the cushion of the turf. It's a little bit more dried out, not the more lush grass. And on the other part of the fairway, a really good angle from this left-hand side of the fairway. 149. As Jim said, probably playing more like 165. Ooh, caught that heavy, fat kind of pull, low left shot, and boy, thank you, slope.
Stop.
I mean, think about the two shots that she's hit, Rich, on this hole. First, the tee shot to avoid the bunker, and then really one of the worst shots we've seen her hit all week to end up right in the middle of the fairway, right in the middle of the green. Did she ever get away with that one?
If you're Monet Chun, Morgan, at this point, you'd be thrilled to get it to three down after 18 holes, right?
Yeah, she's got to just find a way to eat into this lead a little bit. There's still plenty of golf to play, but she's got to start seeing something go her way. That ninth hole was only the second hole it's been halved all day. It's been predominantly the Saki show, but Monet was able to win the sixth hole.
Baba has made birdies at 2, 4, 5, and 8. Again, if you're Monet Chun, a little bit like a basketball game. Your teams will find themselves in an early first half hole down 20-25. Maybe the other club has caught fire from deep. And you'll hear it often said, let's just cut it to 10 or 12 by the half. And then put some pressure on and make your opponent think.
Yeah, she can't get, she can't try to, you're not going to pick it all up in one hole.
How about the wedge here? We saw this yesterday just off the green when most people would putt it, particularly as closely mown as it is here, and she elects to use that club. What's at work?
Yeah, her hands are spectacular. My cousin is her teammate at Michigan, and she told me this when I talked to her the other day. She said, Monet will chip from 1 inch off the green. So statistically, she is a better chipper than a putter and has a better chance with the wedge in her hand. And she is clearly very comfortable. And I mean, looking at that, granted, I'm not down there, but I would pull a putter. But that's how she feels the most comfortable. She chips in very often, once or twice a round.
She had a downhill look yesterday at the sixth. We thought putter. She pulled that club, she chipped it, and went long and missed the comeback. So made bogey there, didn't work out.
I still don't think that was a bad decision in that sense. I don't know that putter could have done much better. I think that was so severe. I think the miss was being over that green on six. I don't think whether she pulled wedge or putter, she could have gotten it much closer. But we'll see if it continues to, she continues to be right on the fringe.
All right, Kay, Saki Baba.
This is a really tough, long putt. This is certainly the longest putt for birdie that she's looked at today. So we'll see how she adjusts her speed control. Uphill, big swale, big mound to her right that'll move this right to left. Yeah, never quite got that high enough, but really, overall, very good putt, especially speed-wise.
Definitely dialed in on the pace there. Look how far right she's aiming for that big knob coming off the right side of the screen. And like Kay said, not high enough, but that's all she kind of needs to do is keep making pars.
Especially in a hole like this, the 10th that has been very difficult throughout the week.
Julia, how much does this chip break right here?
Well, she's taking out a lot of the initial break going with the wedge, I think. She's going to land it a couple feet on the green, and that's where the majority of this break is right at the fringe. She's going with the 58 degree here. She's looking pretty high, though, about 6 feet. Just never hit it hard enough.
Yeah, I mean, I think you go to the old adage, what everybody is told is a bad putt is usually better than a bad chip. And just kind of scooped it a little bit, spun a little bit more than she was anticipating off of her face.
She had a 54 degree initially and came back to her back, switched it out for a 58, and I was kind of surprised by that. She likes to hit those low shots. I think she, like you said, just scooped it a little bit too much.
She's got to be standing over that chip thinking she's going to hole it. And instead, here she's left with the tester for par.
Yeah, about 4.5 feet, moving left to right the whole way. One of those putts you just have to play barely outside the hole and stay really committed to your line. You don't want to push it in or do anything crazy here.
solid stroke. I mean, with that solid of a stroke, use that from the fringe too. It looks like her short game in general is pretty second to none, but you can't keep making it that hard on yourself when you're five down.
Baba now to tie the hole, stay five up.
Yep. Good stroke. Confident stroke.
These are the putts that you practice hundreds, thousands of times. The 2, 3, 4 footers, particularly ones that are little sliders. If you're comfortable with these putts, chances are you're going to be playing a very good tournament week.
Saki Baba remains 5-up.
Tour de force for Saki Baba. And time now for signature moments presented by Rolex. And we'll take you back to last year at Westchester Country Club. And for birdie to win the hole at Jensen Castle. Comes right back. She was a 63 seed coming in. University of Kentucky junior. She opened the week with 7 over 79 in stroke play, then survived the 12-for-2 playoff just to reach match play. Had a stress fracture in her ribs a month prior. Expectations so low she didn't pack enough outfits for her winning run. That was some week. The defending champ made it back this year, but was taken out very early in match play. Just a gorgeous day here, University Place, Washington, outside of Tacoma. Now let's take you back to some action from earlier in this championship match.
Saki Baba, 5 up through 10, and on the tee here at the par 4 11th.
Hey, the sand on the right comes in at 250 yards. Basically want to hit it right over that mound, that dune mound in the middle of the fairway.
Good one by the 17-year-old. Now Monet Chun, driver in hand.
And she'll need all of this. This is a little bit of a longer hole, so I'm looking to put an extra gear into this one. She's very accurate, though, going over the center of that dune.
Yeah. Well, Morgan, if you're Monet Chun, it starts with shots like that. Hit the fairways, hit the greens, give yourself an opportunity each and every hole to try to claw back into it.
Yeah, she can't make any more mistakes. She's made a few mistakes on this front nine, three putting eight, kind of wrapped up the seventh hole nicely in a little gift box, and she can't keep doing that. You're not going to have any form of a comeback against Saki Baba if you keep throwing holes away like that. So she has to just straighten it out a little bit, keep doing what we've seen her do the rest of the week.
Let's send it down to Jim at 11.
Thanks, Berko. Excuse me, Berko. Tees have moved up about 30 yards today, but it was very interesting. These fairways have been firm all week. Both balls really didn't get much roll. Saki Baba's right here. It actually only rolled about 10 feet. She's a little bit on this upslope, which can have the tendency to move the ball from right to left. And with the hole location on that left side, that's a good thing. I don't think they're going to use the slope to the right of the green. They have when they've had longer shots in there. But I think anything kind of the center green will kind of feed over to the left, and that's the key on this shot. As we move up to Monet's ball, her ball's a little above her feet as well. She's going to probably have to be a little bit more aggressive, being down as many as she is, maybe a little bit above her feet and a little bit on the downhill.
Yeah, being a little bit on the downhill makes it harder. Now, what is the risk that Monet runs being too aggressive, Jim?
Well, if you're going to go right at it, you have to carry it all the way up there just short. There is a mound short that will kind of be, it will kind of feed it to the left. But if you get too aggressive and you miss this green to the left, it's going to feed off 30, 40 yards off to the left. You do not want to do that. So the suggestion here, just right of the hole location.
Smart.
We'll see what they do with their seconds here at the 11th. Again, Baba maintaining that 5-up lead.
Uninterrupted coverage of the USGA Championships is presented by Rolex. It was a masterclass today by the young Japanese sensation, Saki Baba. And now back to some of the play from the first 18.
Baba getting ready to go first here at 11 with her second.
50 yards to the front, 167 to the hole. It's maybe a little bit softer this morning. So firm up as the builders on the side of the screen. It was quite a bit yesterday afternoon.
Nice and smooth. Smooth, okay. Stay right.
Struck beautifully. A very aggressive line. Right over the flag stick.
She said that in her interview yesterday, that she aimed right at every flag. Even being five up, there's no defensive play. I guess stick with what works.
Yeah, why change now? If you're Saki Baba. Now Monet Chun, Julia.
150's made it this hole. Well, Saki will her feet. Difficult to spin it, but she does come up the top a little bit. And this is on a really good line, just barely right.
Oh, this is beautiful. That's what Monet needs to do, and do it often. She's left herself in a wonderful spot.
So Chun, a chance for birdie coming up at the 11, trying to chip in that advantage. Saki Baba currently has.
All right, no matter your age, gender or skill, a handicap index provides every golfer with a universal measure of playing ability and enhances the fun and social aspects of your game. To get your handicap index and receive other great benefits from your local Allied Golf Association, sign up at usga.org/get a handicap. Saki Baba, going back to World War II, joins this illustrious group, winning a U.S. Women's Amateur in their first attempt. The babe, one of the greatest athletes in the history of sport, period. Beth Daniel won it twice. Saki joining Michiko Hattori as Japanese winners of the U.S. Women's Amateur Championship. Sylvia Cavallari from Italy. Kimberly Kim was just 14 when she won it. Let's take you back to some of the action from earlier today.
Green at 11, couple of birdie putts upcoming. Saki Baba first to go.
Yeah, this is another long birdie putt. I mean, that was a beautiful shot in, just probably in between clubs, carried it a little farther than she would have liked, and it released all the way back out to the back part of the screen, leaving her a challenging two putt.
Yeah, I think this one is significantly more challenging than the one in the last hole, okay?
Yes, she has a, sort of a big mound. It's kind of the line that defines that shelf where the hole's located, where she and her caddy, Bo Brushert, are standing is just about where she wants to kind of get that ball to apex, and then gravity's going to pull it down to the right towards the hole.
That's pretty much what they're looking at. They're looking at Bo's trying to tell her, look, if you come right here, it's going to take it all the way down to the hole.
Based off basically 12 paces from that point to her coin. So she's looking at a 36-foot putt to try to imagine that the hole is at that 36-foot point, and then let again the natural speed take over from there. When you're putting a putt like this, you have to sort of forget about the hole and think about the track and the process and the point where you want to hit it to.
Thank you.
little off as well, that combination and keeping it short and right.
Oh, here's an opening.
An opening Monet Chun needs to take advantage of, Julia.
And it really says a putt here. She got it on the correct shelf. Very flat putt. If anything, a little uphill. Moving right to left the whole way. Just 20 feet in would be a really nice putt to make. Get some momentum back.
Morgan also considering the fact that Baba still has some work to do. Two chances, perhaps, for Chun to pick up a win here.
Yeah, you can't expect your opponent to miss it, but you also know in the back of your mind that you can't be too aggressive here. Again, like I said, you don't want to throw away any more holes.
That's a really aggressive putt.
The one thing you didn't want to do there if you're Monet Chun.
You want to try and make it, but you also want to make sure that you leave yourself with a concession for the second.
You want that ball in your hand right now, knowing you're in with four.
Yeah, leaving a putt of that distance just adds more stress, takes more energy, doesn't allow you to relax. Morgan, you know better than anybody, it's so important to just lag your putts up there, be able to put it in your pocket, and completely relax at the edge of the green.
Well, and usually, too, I mean, when you have speed that is off, it typically doesn't go in either.
Mm-mm.
So you think, oh, I've got to be more aggressive with this putt, but that doesn't always result in a higher chance of the putt falling.
Not a good feeling to be down in a match and not be totally confident of your speed on these greens. Now this is a good 8-9 footer, a little bit downhill, pulling to the right.
For Monet to just watch that, you think, okay, maybe I can start to claw my way back here. And now this is the risk of hitting that first putt long, Julia. Now she got to make this just to stay five down.
Yeah, she was in the driver's seat on this hole, walking up to the screen, and now she has to make a putt, and not a short putt, to have the hole. So not what she wanted when she was walking up to the screen. Not much to this putt, though.
She made a beautiful stroke on the last one.
So Monet Chun able to two-putt there at the 11, but work to do, five down to Baba.
Baba remains five up.
And let's take a look at our upcoming USGA broadcast schedule presented by Rolex. 122nd U.S. Amateur, the round of 64 from Ridgewood in New Jersey. Coverage beginning Wednesday on Peacock and Golf Channel. USGA Championships in the books. G. Lee announcing her arrival in full. She's one of the best players in the world. Curtis Cup at Marion was memorable. That goes to the USA. Matt Fitzpatrick, what I thought was maybe the best U.S. Open in 25 years. Harrington with his speed and power at Saucon Valley. Donna Wilson and Wenyi Deng winning the junior amateur titles. U.S. Senior Women's Open, the Senior Amateur, the World Amateur Team Championship, U.S. Mid-Am in September, as well as the U.S. Women's Mid-Amateur. A lot of competition still ahead. In this one, it was Saki Baba in dominant fashion, an extraordinary display of high-level golf and poise. We'll take you back to show you how she built that commanding lead.
Up the hill, short and exciting par 4 12th at 278 yards. Saki Baba, five up.
Yeah, today, even though she's been playing very aggressive, smart play here to just go with hybrid off the tee, not able to get it up that hill to the front of the green this morning, maybe perhaps this afternoon.
They're expected to move the tee up K this afternoon, so I would think the players in the afternoon will go for it, but they can't quite get it up there, so there's no point. Monet here Julia going less than driver as well.
Yeah, it's just her. She has a 5-wood in her bag. She hasn't hit a lot this week, but she's hit it on this hole.
There's a little bit of a tug.
Yeah, might can move it up. 35, 40 yards for the afternoon. And almost every hole here at Chambers Bay has about 150 yards of these ribbon tees, so they have a lot of flexibility in terms of yardages every day. Let's go down to Jim.
Thanks, Rich. Both players have played up. Monet got a pretty good kick off that slope. But the big key here is where this hole is located. If you remember back in Wednesday's matches, it was on the same shelf. And they've got it, it's 27 steps back, but you've got to carry it about 22 to get to that upper shelf. If the players choose to use the backstop, it could come off a little bit too fast. So it's a pretty easy hole location compared to Wednesday's. Very accessible. There are some slopes. Ball's maybe a little bit below both players' feet. And I think the key here, picking that yardage, it does play uphill, maybe about a half a club. So these players have practiced a lot of times. They've been on different areas with know how far these balls carry, but this is a key shot right here.
And I think what's important, Jim, is to how much of that slope do you use, if any? What would you recommend?
I wouldn't probably use that backstop much because we saw what happened in on Wednesday. The balls come off so fast. So there's room to land it short of this hole location. That'd be the play. And if it just kind of skips up, it's okay. But if you try to use the backstop all the way back, could come all the way back to the front of the green.
I agree. We've seen that players try to use the slopes around this golf course, and it works sometimes to your disadvantage.
Give you a look at some of the great champions through the years. We'll go back to the 1980s. Julie Engstrom won three straight. And you see from Japan, Michiko Hattori. Kay Cockrell, two in a row, 86 and 87. Pearl Sin, Vicky Goetz. Amateur standouts. Then, as you begin the 90s, Pat Hurst, who went on to have a really good professional career. Kelly Keeney, back-to-back. Cavalieri was from Italy. Into the early 2000s. And is that a 2005 right there?
It was a special year, 2005. Certainly a special year for me, but always an honor to be on this list.
You almost won the U.S. Women's Open a month before you won the Amateur.
Yeah, and I knew that that was going to be my very last big professional or big amateur event, excuse me, before turning professional. And I mean, just this list, the greatest players.
Kang back to back. Lydia Ko has gone on to do so much in the professional game. And then Gabriella Ruffles from Australia winning it 3 years ago. And we'll take you back now to some of the golf from earlier in this 36-hole championship match.
Second shots now at this little par 4, 12th right up the hill. Julia Johnson is with Monet Chun.
She just has 89 yards. Ball is slightly below her feet. Probably playing half a club up. I just hit this the number 89, 88. Keep it slightly below this hole.
Use the slope on the eighth hole to her disadvantage. Let's see if she can dial this one in. There you go. That will remain in the top shelf.
And now Saki Baba.
I think in this instance, Morgan, I'd be happy to play second. First of all, to get a little extra chance to catch your breath up this steep incline, basically 50 feet straight uphill from the tee to the green, and then you can see one more look at how the ball might react. Going a little more aggressively past the hole.
Oh, and she is able to control her spin. I expected that to come whipping back off that slope, but both players will have a similar birdie putt. Looks like Monet will putt first, maybe have the opportunity to hole a putt and put some pressure here on Saki.
What strikes you when you watch Saki Baba swing the club?
She looks fearless. I guess most 17-year-olds do look relatively fearless, but she steps up very confidently. You know, she goes right after every pin. And when you're firing on all cylinders like she is, that That's usually a pretty good recipe for success.
And Morgan, don't you think it's been a kind of a breakout summer for her, where she's come over to the United States for the first time? She qualified for the U.S. Women's Open, was one of the four amateurs to make the cut there, played all 4 days, learned a lot from that experience, co-medalist at the Girls Junior. Yes, she lost in the second round of matches, but it's like it's been a big hello world, I'm Saki Baba. And all of Japan is just incredibly excited for her.
As they should be. I think she's going to be an absolute superstar based on what we've seen so far. And I think the second round loss at the Girls Junior was more due to lack of match play experience. I mean, she's even this week is relying heavily on her caddy to help with concessions, when to concede, and what to do around that. And there's a lot of strategy in match play where if you've never really played match play before on such a big stage, you don't really know what to do.
Chun could use this.
About 12 feet down the hill, moving right to left the whole way. It's been about two balls out here, maybe three.
Kind of whiffed a little
bit. She knew it right away. I don't know if it came off the club face poorly or hopped early, but we need to a little bit more of a confident stroke there.
After hitting the last putt by so far, Morgan, do you think that she might have been a little tentative there?
Yeah, I do. I think that you kind of talked about how much patience she has, but at some point you kind of might start to get frustrated with yourself. And
Morgan, that confidence that Saki Baba has created today really comes through the basic fundamentals of the game today. She has only missed one fairway and one green, so she's only made one major mistake, a conceded hole loss on the sixth hole after she hit it up in the dunes, but other than that, it's been near perfection.
And if she were to make this right here, Kay, this would be another dagger.
They go to the par 513. Saki Baba's five up.
Means five up.
These two finalists producing what we thought were the two best shots or most memorable shots of the championship. Go back to the quarterfinals, this short par 412 right up to here, a hill, and here is Baba.
To the most challenging hole location on this 12th hole, on this top little shelf.
Finals, it's a great match against Brianna Navarroza and Chun, tied at the 17th.
She just lost a couple of holes in a row, so this was a really big moment to get back in control.
Here's your champion. Gold medal, a beautiful Robert Knox trophy for 1 year, which you know all about. He won it in 2005. I'm sure she'll stay amateur to play in the next 10, but if she does, it's a nice luxury. I think the best of all is the invitation to Pebble Beach, the U.S. Women's Open next summer.
No question. She's going to have the opportunity to continue to test her game at the highest level. You see there on the bottom as well, potentially getting in the Chevron Evian Championship, the AIG Women's Open. There is a lot of golf in her future at high level, and she'll really be able to test herself and continue to improve.
By the way, she did today, and this week, who knows, she could challenge at some of those LPGA Major Championships next year. Let's take you back to the golf from earlier today.
Baba, five up on the tee here at the par 513.
So many of these tees are purposely a little less than level. allowing the players to kind of go to one side or the other to help accentuate a cut or a draw. Saki going right down the middle and pretty much hitting a dead straight drive.
Kay said that a few times today, Morgan, after a shot by Baba.
You don't really need one on this hole. I mean, I think I could probably find this fairway these days, 103 yards wide.
I like your chances. Now, Chun.
Shot.
You know that Monet shifted her game plan on this hole yesterday, and I would expect her to go with a similar game plan here today. I mean, wow, look at those two players. She'll play first. I don't think she'll play too aggressively, so we'll put pressure in that regard on Saki Baba, but I'd expect both players to lay up short left of the pretty big bunker short of the green.
That's an interesting point you made there, Morgan, that a lot of these young women say, I've got a game plan all week long, and I'm going to stick to my plan. Huh? Monet was able to reassess, pivot, at least on this particular hole. Once she gets to the break for lunch, how much of a positive could that be that she realizes, maybe I need to change a lot more of my game plan if I'm going to try to catch her?
Yeah, I don't know from what we've seen so far, if her game plan so much she's changed, but she just needs to execute better. So there's that balance, right? Did I make a poor decision or did I hit a poor shot? And that's something that she will need to analyze at the break.
Send it down to Jimmy.
Yeah, as Morgan said, I think both players are going to lay up back here, a little bit back into the wind. Baba did lay up yesterday. The big key here is avoid the bunker. It's about 30 yards short and just somewhere to get a decent angle. The thing is, the hole location's cut on the left side. There's a giant mound just short, so they're going to have to carry it on there. If you can sneak it up the right side, which will be a little more of an aggressive layup, you get a little better angle coming in there. If you get over on that left side of the fairway, it makes it a lot tougher third shot.
Yeah, that's that convex slope front and left of this hole location is the hole today is probably one of the most challenging on this green to get it close to. And I like what you said, Jimmy, about hitting it up the right to get a better angle. But up the right, you definitely risk flirting with those bunkers, and that's where we saw Monet the other day. So it would be interesting to see what they choose to do here.
Exactly, and if you do go left, you cannot see the putting surface because of that mound. So that's another thing that kind of plays with the players' minds, and you got to be really accurate with that wedge shot.
Yeah, and we saw yesterday, I believe it was Annabelle Wilson, hit the front of that convex slope and come back all the way into the bunker. So it's a tricky wedge shot here, pretty much from any angle, but a little bit safer up the right.
You can enjoy the golf or hop on a paddleboard. Get out there on Puget Sound on a championship Sunday.
Saki Baba with an exceptional display today in every single way on her way to an 11-9 victory over Canada's Monet Chun. That matches the third largest margin of victory in the history of this championship. James Harrius also won 11-9 back in 1946. years old from Japan, beating the 21-year-old from Canada. Running away. Morgan did it in 2005. And Sander from the state of Washington, all-time largest margin back. 61 years ago, that was some performance today by Saki Baba.
I think we're seeing something really special here today, Rich. It was truly a performance of a lifetime. I still say that the very best golf I've ever played in my life was when I hoisted that trophy, and Saki may at some point in the future say the same, because it was pretty phenomenal to watch her this week, and I'm excited to watch her in the future. She's such a young superstar with so much endless potential.
Yeah. Her caddy, I think, said it best. Poise, polish. She putted lights out this week. She went after flag sticks, and she was fearless. This one was absolutely memorable. I enjoyed this, Morgan. We'll catch up with you down the road. 122nd U.S. Amateur from Ridgewood. Stacked field of great amateur players getting underway Wednesday, 3 o'clock on Peacock, then 4 o'clock on Golf Channel. Championship coverage was presented by Rolex, this 122nd U.S. Women's Amateur. Golf Central is coming up next. Many thanks to the great people here at Chambers Bay. Zach Keener, the general manager from the USGA. Laura Nota, who was the director of this championship. Hats off to Grant Packer and Jeff Jastro, leading all the hardworking women and men in the trucking on the ground, from Morgan, Steve Bukowski, Kay Cockrell, Jim Gallagher Jr., Julia Johnson, Catherine Belanger. I'm Rich Lerner. So long from Chambers Bay, Saki Baba.